Hello, Chen.
Everybody ready for some more video game Christmas cake? Hold on a second, I just really gotta clean up a mess. Be right back, I gotta get a paper towel. Fluids here, look. I think Dex tried to mark my keyboard a little bit. This is her keyboard now, Chen, not mine. Or at least, I think that's what she thinks. I don't know if pressing the Alt button is going to do anything right now, but I gotta press it in if I want to clean it. Caused the game to crash. Pressing just Alt caused the game to crash. Interesting. This crash brought to you by my cat, who decided to pee on my Alt button when I went to right as I turned the stream on and left my office chair. Normally, you have to press like Alt F4, chat, before a game will just like end like that. This game just took pressing of the Alt button. Interesting. God damn it, Dex. What'd you do? Why'd you make a mess of everything already? Bad kitty. The button will crash a Bethesda game? Thinking about a Bethesda game can cause a game to crash. Hold up. Okay. Let me get the game going again. One comment I saw said that there's a good side quest you're supposed to play in conjunction with the main story. I know you probably won't do it, but people may point that out in the comments of your sim video for this game. Is it the one where you work for the people after you like get some contraband and they like take you on their ship and then they recruit you to work against the Crimson, whatever they are? Because I picked that one up. I just haven't started work on it yet. Who knows? I might end up doing that one. All right, let's see if the game will like now work. You download those mods? Actually, I didn't. Instead, I just moved all my, just like earlier today, I moved my inventory that I had to like stash in that chest last night back to my ship. I couldn't find a reliable or good mod that would increase inventory space. Most of the mods that I kept finding were for other things related to inventory. Like some of them increase like the travel distance. Like apparently you can like send stuff in your personal inventory back to your ship if you're close with, if you're within like a few hundred meters of your ship. There's like some that increase that distance. I'm sure there's mods that increase the amount of weight you can carry, but I couldn't find a good one. I was like, you know what? I'll hold off. So I just moved everything that I didn't need into my ship. Hopefully we don't get hit by the bug again. Just turn your ship into a... I'm actually going to be building a new ship tonight, I feel. I need to do that, because I'm... Whenever I've had to get into, like, combat in space now, I'm getting, like, pasted. And I've got, like, a decent amount of money on me, so I should build a new one. Alright, I'm gonna hit Alt-Tab again so I can, like, get to my Discord and stuff. There we go. Gotta send out announce moves, chat. Last hour was rough last night. I have not had a single smooth hour in this game. That was just an extra rough hour. Alright, announcements done. Now I can focus all my attention on the Todd slop. You think Todd appreciates how much people make fun of him? You think he's like cool with it? He's like, you know what? Be my guest. Pardon me likes to think he's down. He's cool with it. Did you hear that Tears of the Kingdom isn't getting any DLC? They supposedly felt like they did everything they could. Well, technically, Tears of the Kingdom started life as DLC for Breath of the Wild, and then it ascended into its own game. So that makes perfect sense. Like, yeah, what would you do? Add, like, an underwater section? I don't know. All they could really do is, like, add more stuff to it, so that's fine. Not every game needs DLC, you know? Especially when the sequel itself essentially was just more DLC. Inventory glitch is an occurrence in which there is a 1 in 10 chance everything a player adds from their player character to storage. The game will not recognize it as being completed and will send all the inventory back to the player. It is unknown what triggers it, nor is there a fix. Interesting. Wonder if it'll happen again then, because it is problematic depending on where it happens. Except Elden Ring needs DLC for Elden Ring. I honestly don't think Elden Ring needs DLC. It's fine, but, you know, more of it is, you know, fine too. I'm not going to complain. Not going to complain. What were you doing when it happened? I literally just traveled back to the lodge and talked to someone. That was it. It might have happened when I spawned into the lodge, because I just didn't notice, because it was just a short walk over to the people. So, I don't know. It does, we need more. You need more of Elden Ring, a game you can play for, like, close to, like, 100 hours, as is. Isn't that Shadow of the Erdtree DLC in the works? Yeah, I'm guessing that's next year. They probably would have announced a release date for it by now. You at least expected Sekiro to get one or two DLCs? Nope, nothing for that one. Not a single one. Though, to be fair, that is their most story-focused game, so maybe they didn't feel they could slot it in as well. Hoping for the Resident Evil 4 deal. You know, actually, I'd kind of forgotten about that. Yeah, we should be getting, like, Codename Ada, right? That's the most obvious DLC for that game. That will probably be early next year, though. Because I don't think there'll be a new Resident Evil game for next year, so they'll probably, like, try to, like, make do with DLC for Resident Evil 4. I wonder how long it will take for them to announce it since Assassin's Creed, okay, Armored Core. Keep seeing AC and like Assassin's Creed. Ada Wong, now that is a real pile of pixel right there. Did you just catcall a video game character? That's essentially what that sounds like. It's like you catcalling. Or having like one of those dirty water cooler conversations with like a coworker. Like, ugh, Jennifer in accounting, my god, man. I don't know what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? That kind of like really like ugh. Only over a fictional video game lady. Interesting. My keyboard now stinks. Thank you, Dex. It was wonderful of you to do that. I can even like wiping it up didn't get rid of it. I guess she wants me to buy a new one. Can't romance characters in this game? I don't care. Have you seen the characters in this game? Would you want to romance any of them? This is the most sexless game I think I've ever come across, other than other Bethesda games. No one in it inspires, like, lust in me. Like, you know what? This is my girlfriend. Like, who? It's like you can get married and stuff in Skyrim, but you only do that so you can have, like, your free perks that come with it. Not because, like, oh, I like this character. You can get married in this game, yeah, but is it just like, say, with Skyrim, where you do it to get a free house and, like, someone to carry your burdens? Install big titty mods. What about just like regular titty? Reaching the point of video games where even just like a C cup would probably be considered huge. There must be one shaggable person in the game. The robot's alright. He seemed pretty like, you know, had a bit of a personality. It's kind of weird that they give you the robot sidekick, but every single person feels robotic as it is. So I barely notice a difference. Sex is lame anyways. Can you be best friends with anyone? That's probably harder. Both require, you know, a human connection with a game that is actually very not human in most ways. I'm good with words, by the way. Very not human. Demodex, why? Dex, why? I don't know why she settled on my keyboard is the thing she had to go mark. I never do to her. There's a good amount of people that really like this game. Well, of course there are. But that's the open world. There's a lot of people who like Fallout 76, despite the shit show that was. And no, this will probably get nominated for Game of the Year, but if it actually were to win, it'd be a... Again, I don't really care about the award show. I mainly watch it for trailers. So it's all ridiculous anyways. But for those of you who do, I would feel a little like, huh, if it did, considering the competition for it this year. Hi, Dart. Say hi to fulfill my parasocial needs for tonight. You know, you don't have to tell me to say hello. If you just say, like, hi, Dart, again, I will probably say hi back to you. Just out of common courtesy. Like, if you came here like, hey, Dart, how you doing today? I'm like, hey, how you doing, man? I'm good. That's just a normal human response. Like, think of that. When have you gone up to someone like, hey, say hi to me? I really need a date. Just say hi to me. Comes off as desperate. Not a good look. Even if you're trying to make the parasocial joke. You can get what you want out of me just by being normal. This is the best year for games since 2017. Well, true. Actually, what released in 2018 again? That was like Resident Evil... was that Resident Evil... No, Village was like 2020 or 2021. Never mind. Can't forget what came out in 2018 and 19. Never forget the 2023 Game Awards when every category had the same three games. Well, can you blame them? Hey, Dargan, please say hi. I need you to say hi to give me my life validations. Okay, this is definitely one of those touch grass situations. I know it's not the greatest advice, but in this case, it might be necessary. But how you doing? And also, thank you for the tier one. At 35 months. Much appreciated. My cat is like going nuts in the background. 2018 Spider-Man, God of War, and those three games were kind of a big deal. That was also the year of Far Cry, 5, wasn't it? I remember like that was like probably like my best year ever in terms of like views. I hit every single one of those games in like a very short span of time and they all did really well. How can I touch grass if all of it where I live is paved with concrete? There's got to be a park somewhere, right? Or maybe you can ask someone in the suburbs if you can touch their lawn. You don't live in like a Walmart parking lot, do you? He was making a joke. So was I. Oh my god. Now I gotta explain stuff like, hey, irony to you guys. And also the idea of the anti-joke. Anti-jokes are just jokes where I try to kill someone else's joke by over-explaining it and treating it like a real thing. You think 2019 might be the best year for games ever? I don't recall 2019 being that particularly special. You mean anti-humor? Yes. Anti-humor, anti-joke, same thing. But I use it in a different way. You know what? And no one ever gets it. Maybe I'm using it incorrectly. Are you going to say hi to me on the Japan trip? I'm just messing with you, good sir. I say hi to everybody. I say hi and then salute, handshake, bow, and throw my coat over puddles in front of them. I'm the friendliest motherfucker you can ever come across. I carry a spare umbrella with me at all times just in case I need to hold it over someone if it starts raining. ...2017 had Breath of the Wild, Nier Automata. Okay, well, we're just like, hey, let's look at that. Let's go back in time and look at the games of, past few years. Yeah, 2017 was a pretty busy year. That was also Resident Evil 7, I believe. How do you throw a puddle at someone? No, you throw your coat over a puddle. You misheard the last part of my sentence. Resident Evil 2, DMC5, Sekiro, Death Stranding, Disco Elysium was there, right? Also, wasn't that Last of Us? Yeah, Last of Us 2 that year? Or am I thinking of something else? You want to see Kingdom Hearts 4? Not because I think it's good, but because I want to see how batshit insane. Maybe now they've wrapped up all the... plot lines from the past 2.5 decades, maybe Kingdom Hearts 4 can be, you know, sane and clean and not be so convoluted because all that stuff's settled now. Well, I say there's still some plot threads they introduce at the end of 3, but, and also some kind of online mobile game or whatever the hell. But majority of their character plot threads were all like, yeah, messily cleaned up, but cleaned up they at least were. So at least they don't have to like spend an entire game basically wrapping up a bunch of all that crap that they put up forward. You don't believe that in the slightest? No, but I can have hope that they might be able to do that. There's no reason why they can't, all right? Other than Nomura. Just having a very awkward way of always never finishing any damn thing he does. In ever, the dude just can't finish. Couldn't finish Final Fantasy 15, so he had to wrap that up in a messy way. Every single time he's the director of a game, it ends up being like, yeah, I had a lot of ideas that I just couldn't make work, so I just stuck half the ideas in there. The dude just gets too carried away with what he wants to, you know, pull off. He's not a good writer. I'm not gonna say he's not a good writer. He's a messy writer. He has written stuff that, well, I'm not sure how much of it he actually writes himself, or he like at least comes up with concepts. He's sometimes pretty good at concepts, just because he is a concept character designer. So sometimes he can come up with a pretty good story concept, but just when he it's kind of fleshing out, he can't really do much with it usually or make it work properly. He's an early ejaculator. Well, you know what? I'll let you be the one to think about that. Bruv. Oh, he likes to be the number 13. Well, a lot of Asian cultures do have fascination with certain numbers. Just superstitions and all that. Spent half of Kingdom Hearts 3 explaining away Shindai. I didn't spend half of Kingdom Hearts 3. All of Kingdom Hearts 3 was them fixing and completing things. Originally wrote a few characters in FF6 like Shadow and Seltzer. I think he did the same. And yeah, that was pretty much his first job, was like designing just a few of the side characters in that game. Since I guess the main character designer, the guy did all them before him, was maybe too busy. Or maybe there were just too many characters. So he's like, hey, we'll let you like handle a few of these. And that was enough to get him like the main lead character designer for 7. Play the other game, sir. That's what I'm saying. So you can beat me Mortal Kombat in 5 to 6 hours. Generally, as a fighting game plotline will only really last anywhere between 5 and 8 hours. It's pretty direct. You know, well, I say that, but Street Fighters is a bit different since it's like full of all sorts of stuff where you like roam around a city. But Mortal Kombat is just like, here's a cutscene that leads into a fight. So there's no actual like roaming around involved. So it goes a bit quicker. Adulthood is when you realize there's more than 3 Kingdom Hearts games. Well, why is chat so hung up on Kingdom Hearts 3? I mean, Kingdom Hearts tonight. Average time is around that 6 to 8 hours from, wait, people have already finished it? It's not even out yet. Oh, like leaked copies, you mean? But yeah, my plan is to beat that entire game single player in one night and then get a video out within a week. Because I gotta leave for like a, you know, thing at the end of the month, you know, a thing, chat. You've never played a Kingdom Hearts game? That's a positive thing. Kingdom Hearts 1 is actually a really good game. So I can recommend that one. Honestly, Kingdom Hearts 2 is pretty good as well, all things considered. It's just where the things start also coming off the rails a bit. But it's mostly an alright game. Some stores sold them early or an NRS is pissed. That always happens though with every game anymore. There's always like some mom and pop gaming shop that just like gets a copy of it, like, yeah, we'll sell some to our, we'll give a few to our family and friends. But like, we'll have like a few customers they'll sell it to under the table. I mean, you can't play it online yet anyway, so it's really only the story. All they're doing is playing the story mode that, yeah, let's be honest, will be pretty forgettable. For the most part. I mean, most fighting games used to barely have any plot, and if they did, it was all in the manual anyways. Mom and Pop Gaming Shop actually sounds like a nice name for a gaming shop. I'm pretty sure I've seen mom and pop stores adopt the whole mom and pop thing into their logo before. Usually what you can expect from a mom and pop store is like horrible prices. Because everything is usually like overpriced. There's a reason they started failing left and right to like department stores, because they're just prices were insane. Like the markup was pretty huge. Horrible? Like, yeah, usually you're paying a little bit more than you would somewhere else for the same thing. And it's not like they're selling like usually handcrafted goods. They're just selling like stuff they bought from wholesalers as well. Now, if it's something they're like, it's unique to them, that's different. Kind of like the price at a convenience shop. Yeah, for a lot of them were just that. It's just convenience shop prices. Like I said, if it's like something that makes its own product, that can be different. But they're just selling the same exact stuff. I can get it like a department store. It's like, why would I bother? I can just get it cheaper there. Don't even like anything useful. It's already anything that's like, you know, unique. But I'm supposed to feel bad because of, you know, because of that. Pay an extra so that Walmart and the like don't take over your neighborhood. I mean, yeah, but have you seen the prices? Who can argue? Maybe they deserve to take it over. Couldn't watch the new FLCL anime. Well, you mean like all the, is that out now? Like I saw a trailer for it a few months back and I've not had any interest in it. Just, you know, it's like all weird looking. Doesn't look at all like FLCL, or at least what I like picture FLCL looking like. Dora was not impressed. I don't think anyone who likes the original FLCL is likely to like what they've been doing with it for like a few years ago and now this year, I guess. It just doesn't look, eh? It's like the people who bought the rights to it just have no understanding of it. They just think, oh, quirky characters. That's all you gotta do. Quirky characters and like a theme of like, use the pillows music. A little bit more than that, you know? Is the touch more. Good thing you don't like FLCL. Okay, shit on the things the rest of us like. Good thing I don't like the things you like. Okay, that's a nice comment. I mean, yeah, there's plenty of things that will meet that criteria. None of the characters were quirky in the original. Well, that's not true. Haruko was certainly quirky. In fact, actually, that's one of the things. Like, the main character was not quirky. The main character wanted to be desperately be, like, a mature adult. But all the adults in his life were quirky and, like, acted like children. Like, his dad was definitely like that. His grandpa, his teacher, the Commander Overrun, even, and, you know, obviously Haruko. So that was actually one of the themes. Like, the main character was just like, I just want to, like, be mature and an adult and like what adults do, but then like all the adults that you actually see were bigger children. Something I'm seeing in more TV shows and games, a writer somehow completely misunderstand how they work, only seeing this. Well, no, it's that they're reinterpreting things for a modern audience. That's a you know, a worrisome phrase whenever you hear it. We're reinterpreting things for the modern audience. It's like, uh-oh. Uh-oh, what are we going to do? Oh, well, not going to be at all the same. You're probably not going to like it. They should just come out and say, we're not making this for people like the original thing. We have it now. What are you going to do, huh? It's almost like an implied threat. Chat, I'm looking forward to Baldur's Gate tomorrow after like a couple days of this game. Like, I need a palate cleanser. Still have the original. I know, that's why I watch it usually like every year or so, and I just largely ignore whatever they're doing. No use getting upset over it. I can't stop it, and I can't make it any better. You got the Sunday blues, but it is Sunday, isn't it? Oh well, what is it? What do the Sunday blues mean? Do you just feel like, oh shit, tomorrow's Monday, or do you like, oh, the end of the week? I've never gotten day blue, any type of day blue, where it's like, oh, it's this day of the week. Gotta feel sad. Sunday is cleaning day for me. Mm-hmm. That's not too bad. Hey, after it's cleaned up, you feel good, right? Will you be able to even come back to Starfield after Baldur's Gate 3? Yes. I mean, I've already, if I can start playing Starfield after playing Baldur's Gate 3, I think I can come back to it. How is Dex super goddamn annoying? She peed on my keyboard right before my stream started. Like, I got up, like, I started the stream, I got up to go get something to drink, came back and found, like a mark, like a piss mark, right on my alt key. And so I had to, like, yeah, let me go get a paper towel and clean that up. Like, thank you, Dex. Much appreciated. Pissy keyboard. Yeah. Well, I cleaned it up. The sign of affection, that's a sign of her marking her territory. A cat's sign of affection is them slow blinking at you, or like rubbing their head on your ankle. I think playing this game will only elevate your appreciation over Baldur's Gate 3. Keep that in mind while playing. Well, I'm aware, trust me. This game has only showed me like what Baldur's Gate 3 is doing so much better. There's like a few things in this game I can't wrap around my head while they're still doing. Here's a hot, I don't think it's not even a hot take. This game, you know how when you like go into a building in this game, it has to like load an entirely new instance? Like you leave the map you're currently on and then enter the building's map because it can't do the building inside the map like, say, any other game released in the past couple of years does. There is no excuse for that. That was fine back, there was a time and place back in like the 2010s, like for Skyrim, where like every building you want to enter had to be its own instance instead of just being built into the map itself. This is no longer acceptable, I feel, for like a game from like a AAA producer that they have to like every single building is a different instance and it's like a different map you have to load in and out. It's ridiculous. They're just like, come on, Bethesda, come the fuck on. Meanwhile, The Witcher 3 had seamless loading for buildings 8 years ago. It's like, what? I mean, I'm not one to usually harp on a video game engine, but if they can't make their engine do even modern stuff like that, they really need to scrap it and get a new engine. I know that's probably like a bitter pill to swallow. They've been using it forever, but at this point, it really seems to be holding them the fuck back. Like, so many problems just seem to be tied to it. And they seem to be incapable of fixing them. Just works. It just works. It just works. I bet that it just works as something like Todd writes multiple times on his walls and like marker as he goes slowly insane. I'm honestly not hating on it, but I'm really struggling to see the appeal in this game. The vibe is just, it's just big. That's it. That's the appeal. It's big and you can go anywhere. But only if you can like click on a menu. I do think Skyrim is a better game because of the sense of adventure is there, because it's like, hey, you're down on the ground, you gotta walk or ride a horse. Whereas this, the whole like traveling on planets seems kind of like less interesting because it's just like, it's just a big barren rock with a few things scattered on it here and there. And space is just like menus. Do you think one reason they don't want to change engines is because they fear that modders will have a harder time modding their game? I'm sure there's multiple very good reasons why they don't want to change engines. One, it's like they'd have to learn an entirely new engine style from what they're currently using, which can take time. They'd probably have to build it themselves rather than license it. I don't think you can just like license Unreal Engine 5 and make a game like a Bethesda RPG. Because it's keeping track of so many things here and there. So they'd have to build it themselves, which they probably don't want to do since that can be terrible. But now they got Microsoft money as well, so there's a less reason not to. Like, if we get, like, Elder Scrolls 6 in, like, 5 years, and it still plays like this, I'm sorry, but if you accept that when that happens, that you're a lost cause. If you're like, no, it's good. Why is everyone complaining about this game? And like, why can't we just like, look, it's perfectly fine if you click on a house and have to load in a new map. Or whatever the hell Bethesda engine does. It's just like at some point something's gonna give with them. It's like you need a new engine, Bethesda. You've got as much out of this one as you can possibly get. Maybe Bethesda paid their executives less, they'd be able to afford better game development. Well, that's the thing, you can have well-paid executives and good games. Other companies manage it. Did I already mention how they originally planned for a voice protag? I think someone mentioned that last night, yes. I'm fine with it not having a voice protagonist. That's not a big issue. It's just like, it's the little things, man. It's the little things that piss me off. It's like the navigating the UI is trash experience, like especially the map system in the game. Everything is confusing and has like a learning curve. I gotta like figure out what they intended for it to be used with. It's like it's a very user unfriendly game is the way I would put it. And also it just feels dated. Despite them, it's like the most advanced game we've ever made. There's mods for all that. Yeah, I'm aware, but I have to judge the game as the developer released it. And as they released it, it is just a fucking user-unfriendly mess. It's like I'm constantly like being confused by how something works and like what? Huh? Why? And the systems in the game and like it's just like ugh. And there's no excuse for that either. Dex seems to like Starfield. She's just horny. Has nothing to do with this video game. More encumbrance issues. Well, I basically took off everything that could. I'm actually really light in the game right now because I only have a few things on me. Speaking of. Might as well get to playing this game here. Yeah, there was one item I found that was weighing me down a lot, and it's ship parts. Those are like 10 pounds a piece, and I had like 7 of them on me. So once I took those off as well, I've got pretty light. So right now, I actually only weigh 62 mass. So I don't really have... I've only got a couple guns on me that I'm using. I'm only got the Mark 1 spacesuit on me. This is the best one I've got. So, I'm pretty good. I keep telling you to store the ship parts. Well, yeah. Apparently, I didn't read your comments. Can you visit our solar... I already have visited our solar system. Saw Earth, even. It's like a dried-up husk. What the fuck? So, yeah. All pretty solid. So we can continue with our adventure tonight. Our adventure chat. It's personal. Has anyone like metagamed a very good like, oh, this is my Starfield build? Someone's had to have done that, right? Yeah, here's the perfect quirks for the Starfield experience. Can I also point out another thing that annoys me? How long you have to hold the E button to pick up something in the environment? Like, you have to hold it like a full second before they'll grab it. I accidentally picked up something as well. I don't need a bowl. I was trying to tell you about the ship parts when I told you to go to the MISC. Well, you could have just said, hey, Dart, ship parts are fucking heavy. Question, if those ship parts remain inside my cargo hold, can I heal myself during combat? Or do I have to have them on my person? You got 8 hours until Baldur's Gate finishes downloading? Well, it is a pretty large... It's like 100 gigabytes, so that's not exactly surprising. But hey, you're in for a good time. Who did... Oh, what?
And you must be the latest poor fool to get dragged into
our... Oh, it's the guy from Deus Ex. I love that guy's voice, but he does not have any other voice but the one, does he? No matter what role he's playing, he sounds like Adam Jensen. Is he a space cowboy? I think that's what you would definitely call him. Space cowboy. And you must be Sam Coe, the Freestar Collective expert, huh?
Whoa.
He stated he lost 100 roles because he only has the one voice. I mean, he says that, but I've seen him in plenty of games.
Trust me. Don't encourage him. Kuriko, by the way. Hi, hi.
Though to be fair, he's only ever been like the lead in like the two Deus Ex games. He's usually like an NPC giver or some type in like most games. Korra.
Nice to meet anyone brave enough to fly the frontier.
Perfect. And you must be the new engineer. Or maybe our new gunner.
Hey, don't spook our new friend.
Might be until October if you play Baldur's Gate. It'll be there when you want to play it.
Honest. Now, let's talk business. Sarah tell you about the expedition?
Only that it was in the Freestar Collective space.
Sure enough, that's where we're heading.
So we're going to space,
the three of
Texas?
Us are heading to Aquila, for a settled planet of the Freestar Collective, and, not coincidentally, the home of their capital, Aquila City.
Welcome to space, Texas.
We'll land in the city's spaceports, but the frontier is our goal. It's rough country. Spawned a lot of stories. And I got a lead on a tale that makes me think one thing. Artifact.
Everything's bigger in space, Texas. He looks like an older, bearded Irvine. I don't know. Have you seen Irvine in high def? Irvine is actually basically like a cowboy twink. He was Leonidas in Assassin's Creed Odyssey and the Penguin in Gotham Knights. So yeah, he does get like some good roles. He just doesn't usually get the lead. You know, people ship Nightwing and Harley Quinn. Haven't they fucked? Pretty sure they've actually no reason to ship them when they've actually, you know, literally docked.
Okay. We'll meet you on board your ship. Talk more when we get
there. I gotta build a new ship before I go anywhere.
Once we land in Aquila, it's gonna be you and me. So if you want to do any freewheeling before then, Cora and I will just be riding passenger.
Take a break. Let's chat.
Feel free to help yourself. Fucked in the one of the animated
I don't drink, but I feel like if I did, now would be a good time for one.
Yeah, at this point, I think everyone that's like a comic book character or villain ends up sleeping with each other. I would not be surprised if like, if some comic book villain has an OnlyFans page as a story plot. Like Poison Ivy like is like has like, hey, I just started up an OnlyFans page. What, you know what? They probably will, they haven't. That sounds actually like what modern writers would do and think is empowering.
I'm afraid I don't really think about it too much in terms of what...
Like, why not? Wouldn't be the weirdest thing they've done. Hell, Bruce Wayne will probably start up an OnlyFans page. How long is the day-night cycle in this game? Because it has been nighttime for quite a while. You got enough money? You don't do it for the money, you do it for the thrill. That's the true secret. Wait, aren't you the guy I just talked to? Or are you just wearing the same exact outfit?
Appreciate the lift.
Is it just me or did his appearance change? Did his hair get lighter? I swear to God, he looked different inside.
The star system Cheyenne is what you're looking for.
I swear to God, he looked a bit different inside. It's like his hair got lighter, maybe. Lighting in this game is schizophrenic. It's not good. That's a better way of putting it. I guess while we're here, we'll do those very shorter side quests we picked up. Tree grove. Locate the biosynthesis. Yeah, we'll go ahead and do this one. This one won't take too long. Everyone looks different once you open them up. Okay, say this into this flower lapel I'm wearing on my shirt real, and you'll speak up. No reason. He has three level trees. Yeah, chat, we're very aware this game is not a looker. I mean, yeah, it definitely looks dated as fuck. There's no getting around that. Which is honestly fine if the gameplay itself is, you know, good, but... game is riding any more bipolar, it would need to be medicated. Honestly, you know there's like a mod where you can like plug ChatGPT into Skyrim and have it control the NPCs? And at least their dialogue? You could probably get better results with that. Alright, looks like we got more Podge. What the? Barret, calm. Calm, Barret. What's up with this? How come my jetpack only works for like a second? Oh, I got hit it multiple times. I can't just hold it. Is that how the jetpack is supposed to work, or you just get like a little burst of it? Until Dawn was a fun, terrible game. Yes. True statement. True statement detected. How do you make jetpacks suck? This game found a way. See what kind of guns I got on show. Until Dawn was supposed to be a PS3 movie game, but it took so long they removed. Honestly, that's a good thing. Wait, did they make it so you can't steal stuff off the counter? Boo, Bethesda, stop being giant pussies. That was like, well, that was awesome back in like the Elder Scrolls. Like, oh, I can see that if what's on sale was like on a counter and you can like lift it.
There's nothing that ensures personal safety and security the way a firearm can.
God right, goddamn right, brother. I mean, sister.
Welcome to Centurion Arsenal.
I love being in Space Merca.
It is my absolute pleasure to assist you with any purchases.
How is game? Is it glitchy as usual? Well, last night we ran into a doozy of one.
Because you will undoubtedly be pleased with your purchase.
Where all the stuff I have stored on my ship was transferred to my person and encumbered me. And I couldn't fast travel back to my ship to put it all there. So I had to like spend about 30 to 40 minutes today before stream transferring by foot all my resources back to my ship.
Is
good
that
times.
A surprise? These are potentially matters of life and death we're talking about here. I'm sure we can find something that suits you.
Calibrated Rattler, Combat Knife, Coachman, Eon, Equinox, Explorer, Kellerman, Marksman, Sniper Rifle, Hit. Interesting. It's $27,000. I'm not buying it. Why do you sell, like, the guns of terrorists? And well, shouldn't that cost a lot if it's, like, of a relic from old Earth? Just got here, what's happening? We're at a weapon store. You know what? I'm not gonna buy any of it.
That's you!
Sorry about that. I think I have the best sneeze out there, chat. It is like classic sneeze. I literally say achoo. A lot of other people, they like repress it. Like, I don't want to be your beef. I thought it would be a commoner saying achoo. But no, here I am.
Definitely better than the last interceptor.
I'm not sure if I want to go up there right now. I just want to collect my plant pods, alright? Marquis de Sade would say you have a sexy sneeze. Sexy sneeze.
Welcome to Chunks. Thanks for choosing Chunks. Which Chunks would you like today?
I'd like to buy some Chunks.
I'm happy to serve you.
Doesn't look good, chat. Chunk potato. Chunk wine. This was just their way of getting away with making one model to represent all the food, wasn't it? You're not getting this one past me, Bethesda. I know how fucking lazy you are. What if we just made like one model and changed some text on it? It's fucking brilliant. Do you recommend it or should I wait for mods to fix this game? I'd wait for like a game of the year version of it, honestly.
Honestly, you're probably better off not thinking about it.
Let's see, this guy's selling the game to you as well. Don't think about it, just buy. This is what this game is. It's like video game cube. Unappetizing to look at, but it will, I guess it'll keep you alive. Buy Todd Cube. It looks like a sperm to me, I'm sorry. I know it's like a biosensor, but come on. You're not fooling anybody. Discover the children's playground, but there are no children.
Zen garden? What?
Dirty mind? No, that's a scientific mind. Different things. Wow, lady, give me that stink eye. This feels creepy, chat. Ugh. Why do you look a little bit like Jesse from FF7?
Everything good?
I'm doing great, actually. Thanks for asking. Just got a new job, a new apartment, so things are looking up.
What's that sound effect for? Why is it so easy to just like, ah? Ugh, I feel like I'm in like one of those like horror movies where like body snatchers have taken over everyone. If using the crouch button is enough to make the Phrases freak out and like not be able to like look at you properly, it's not a good sign.
Ask in the security office.
Well, the commercials. That's the start of the gangbang. Have you ever seen one? How many gangbangs have you seen in person? Welcome to the Cloud District. Terra Brew, I could use... Didn't we come across a coffee place? This is like a competing coffee place.
Working at the Office of Interstellar Affairs.
Traffic is good.
Hi there, welcome to Terra Brew. How can I help you?
And certainly.
Oh yeah, I know, it's the same one.
Is it New Atlantis?
You know what, I'll buy a coffee. Give me, they all do the exact same thing. A bit sick. Here, give me an espresso.
This didn't dip at all when the second store opened.
Impressive.
Times change.
Don't ask questions you want answered. I want all the questions answered though. Hey, I got your plant stuff.
Hey, are you looking for eggs too? I've only found one so far, but I want to find more before anyone else does. So if you see some, can you tell me? Okay, well, if I see any of those, I'll tell you. And you can tell me if you find any eggs. Miss Seng over at UC Distribution bought the one I found, and she said she might buy more if I can find them. I could really use the credits.
Gee. You must note 5, okay. Is this some kind of Nurse Joy situation? What? Where everyone looks the same, but they don't have an explanation for it. Actually, was there ever an explanation for that in the world of Pokemon? How they all, why they all, like, just nurses and police officers with the same character, other than it being kind of funny. They were family? Okay, that's a very, no family is that identical, unless there's been some, you know, weird stuff happening.
Hey, Dusty. If you're ever thinking to yourself, oh, I could really listen to Barrett's dulcet voice right now. Then instead of dreaming about
me, am I high? You're like vibrating. Hello,
okay?
Like, no, dude, stand still. You're like vibrating over there.
Bulk items may require multiple levels of approval and can take up to several weeks for an official response.
Seems like the Crescent fleet is everywhere these days.
Welcome to UC Distribution. Now, before you say a word, I am required to inform you that formal...
Can you mind? I'm having a conversation with this lady.
Feedback system is back online. I have been told it'll be up and running in 2 weeks, but you know how these things are. I am
sorry
for any potential inconvenience. Also, if you're here about a corporate account, I've been assured that deliveries will be back on schedule soon.
Like, lady, this is just awkward. Bun egg.
Who, Jordan? That kid's in here every other day with some random thing he found. Trying to get credits. Yeah, I took pity on him.
What?
Why, what is it?
Stop looking at me, you're freaking me out. Sensitive scientific equipment.
Oh, really? Well, you can have it back for what I paid for it, plus a little extra. Let's call it a convenience fee, shall we? I could, but I did pay for it. I'd like to recover my losses. And it's all the way in the back room. I'd have to walk back there, then back out here. You did say this was important after all. Honestly, it's probably worth way more.
Fine.
Pleasure doing this.
I thought you had to walk back there.
I hope we have what you need.
You don't. You got basic shit. Hello, that's 38,000 though. Yeah, it's a little outside my, well, I could buy it, but I need to buy a ship first, so I'm not buying those right now. But, you know, I wouldn't mind a minigun. Shattering, break through even the strongest armor. Your friend over there, I gotta go. She's like, won't stop eyeballing me.
Back to it then.
Install a mod to give you infinite resources and money. Okay, there's a certain level of cheating that I'm not cool with, and that just like makes the point, okay, what's the point then?
I'm pleased to report that our stocks are currently being maintained at 90% or higher. I'm sure we have anything you might need.
Should have just walked in here and stole the damn things. I'm paying $100 for it. Not cheating, it's helping. There's certain things that are helping, and there's certain things that are just like, eh. Even I'm not gonna do. Her name is Sing. We already have. Okay, I don't think. Okay, Sing is not that uncommon of a name. Not that every single person who's named it is gonna be named after a character in FF7. How many things do you know? In my neck of the wood, it's not a common name, but this is a multicultural, diverse future story set in space. Wouldn't be an issue. Yeah, if we come across a Tifa or a Yuffie, then you got an argument. trying to make the game more interesting. Did you not see that weird person staring at me? That was all you really need. Just fuck up every single cutscene you get into and the game is actually pretty good. Because then you can have at least unintentional comedy. Here, I'll show you.
Can you believe this tree was here before the city?
Any luck tracking down those sensors?
Oh, I can't talk to someone when I'm crouched down? Okay.
Hey, if you have time, I've been thinking about some things. Wanted to talk to you about it.
What if I'm, like, jumping?
I appreciate your assistance, but I still need all of those sensors.
So you do. Wonderful. I'll just take these, and we'll see what they have to tell us.
Who's better, the guy teleporting in? Yeah, the teleporting guy was funnier.
A moment. And just another moment. It is working, isn't it? There it is. Leaf. Now, let's see. This is... Well, it's... Oh, my.
Oh.
Well, there's good news and bad news. The good news is that my suspicions were correct. There is something wrong with the tree. I will report my findings to Mast immediately with no small amount of satisfaction. The phrase, "I told you so," may even be uttered.
You're reading Snow Crash earlier, and the main character apparently has a camera fetish? A camera fetish? In Snow Crash? I don't remember him having a camera fetish. I think you might be reading into something.
Well, from a certain point of view. In an admittedly somewhat selfish manner. The bad news, as it were, is that the internal composition of the tree is changing. In this particular case, the tree is now regularly emitting ultra-low frequency sound waves. They're nearly imperceptible now. But they're growing in strength.
The minigun, the question you must ask
this
yourself
is something not, we've never observed
the question
before.
Is, can I afford to live without
depending
it?
On
I'll
how
be
large
fine.
These waves grow, consequences for the city could be disastrous. I must consult with my colleagues.
The tree makes
once.
Noise. The city
Thank
is
you
doomed.
For your assistance. I hope these credits are adequate compensation.
Did Dargan find out something about the mystery artifact and just that we need more of them? That's all we know. We need more of them. God, you have another quest already? You just walked away from me.
The data from the biosensors speaks for itself. These findings are... Let's hope that Mast takes... Thank you for your... The data from... Let's hope
okay, maybe not. Maybe I'll come back later. Talking tree quest. Oh, that was only going to be a one-off. What else do we got? We got Jim Jealousy. Asked me to get his gym back from George St. George. Hopefully this plate is enough to, for George to make the... Oh yeah, we gotta get rid of the stupid plate. Is that plane flying over in space? It's probably like a shuttle or something. Just a shuttle. You know, it'd be nice if we could do that when we're on a planet, but no.
I need the bar. I have a feeling today's going to be a great day. Don't you?
Spaceport. I do think the reason they don't give you any vehicles to drive on yourself is because this their engine can't handle it. Because the way this engine works is it loads things in by chunks. And it probably needs you to be very slow to do that accurately, because this thing is held together by, like, rocks at this point. Rocks and sap. A little bit of tree resin and some, like, charcoal thrown together. So if they let you, like, move to it through fast, like, stuff won't load in. Don't run for more than 5 seconds or okay. Can you believe this guy's gonna save the universe when that's his lung capacity?
Can I help you with something, my friend?
Yeah, your fashion sense. What the fuck? What the hell? What even are those? You are one of the ugliest NPC characters I've ever come across. Like, you, let me put on my quilted gray sweater, my skin tight, like, sweat yoga pants, and that also count as my shoes. It's like a full slip on over.
What?
None of it works with you.
Wasn't
that all bad
in the transfer from last week?
No, you look like that was for handling the shipments, not deliveries.
Oh, okay. I'll try and remember. I swear, lately I feel like I'm spending more time at Galbank than I am here.
A blade? Oh my. As in a blade from Earth? Absolutely. Without question.
It's your father?
Here, take this
I'm
gem.
I'm sorry, this is just one ugly outfit.
That Guillaume, if he wanted his gem back so badly, he could have simply asked.
Fashion terrorist.
Worthless. Less than a paperweight. But actually, Earth paperweights are quite valuable. Bah, I'm sure Guillaume makes it seem that way. In reality,
he's French, that's the reason.
Guillaume and I have known each other for years. Since we were both young men, he is the closest thing I have to a brother. And, much like brothers, we quarrel. But that doesn't mean we don't like each other. I will say, however, Guillaume can be a tad overdramatic.
By the way, Chad, did I did upload and like make my YouTube announcement live, right?
Me? Why, to be frank, I don't do much. Not anymore.
Oh, I did, thank you. Wasn't sure if I'd done that or not.
That suits me just fine. Yes. I now leave to collect artifacts from.
No, I suddenly don't care. I don't want to look at this guy anymore. I'm afraid he might give me another side quest
it's
too. I'm like keeping up.
Bosses as art nowadays.
Hey, that guy across the street. Here's the thing.
Take it from an
I
old
keep
man.
Telling them
everything.
I am a man.
Ah, wonderful. I knew George would make the exchange. He could never resist foodware from Earth. You've done me a great service today, friend. I'll be sure to never take this gem for granted ever again. Thank you for bringing it back to me.
Money, thank you. We need money for building a better spaceship, Chad. That's our goal. The art dealer asked me to pick up some artwork from Zoe Kaminsky, the Trade Authority, and then we got that. We'll do these two, and then we'll build a ship. You like that NPC's design? Yeah, there's a reason why he was the cool NPC in that quest, I guess. The wow. No, everything being something I gotta load in also makes exploration less interesting as well. Are you gonna play Liza P? More than likely. I played the demo of it and it's pretty solid. I'm waiting to see like I said, there's that, plus there's Lords of the Fallen coming out. So I probably won't have time to play both of them, so it'll probably be either or. Like, Lords of the Fallen is looking pretty good too.
Got a moment? Let's catch up.
Nope.
Seriously?
No. Zoro from One Piece. I heard like the Netflix show of like One Piece, people were saying it was pretty good. I'm not gonna watch it because I don't really care about One Piece. But I was actually surprised because I thought that was like adaptable to like real actors. Pharmaceutical kit. I'll be still in that if I take it. Lords of the Fallen is almost a month after Liza P. I mean, true, but there's also a lot of stuff coming out at the same time, so I can't really... I won't be able to finish it quickly is the problem.
You don't need to wear your helmet on this planet. You know that, right?
Is that a problem?
Hey, Dusty. If you're ever thinking to yourself, I could really listen to Barrett's dulcet voice right now. Then instead of dreaming about me, stop by and say hello, okay?
Are you lonely? That's like the second time you tried to get a start of a conversation with me. They're wearing helmets. They're not wearing space helmets, though.
The Trade Authority has access to goods and services no one else does. No one. Welcome to the Trade Authority. If you're here on legitimate business, I would be more than happy to help you. If, however, you are here under false pretense, say, sent by one Miss Tsang of UC Distribution, then I'm afraid you'll find nothing illegitimate here to report to her. And I'd ask that you pass along my request to stop these silly games. So, what'll it be?
Strange way to introduce yourself.
Perhaps. But I'm quite confident in my business, and I refuse to be intimidated. Please, let me know if I can assist you further. Yes, I've been expecting you. Here's your package. And don't worry, I've already corrected the ownership record for you.
Oh.
Good. I'm glad we understand each other.
I'm committing crimes.
Thanks for your business.
Think. I'm interested in doing work for the Trade Authority.
That depends. If you have a ship and are willing to haul cargo, then we've got some work. Otherwise, you're gonna have to be more specific. We frequently post cargo running jobs up on the mission boards around town. Check them out. I've heard our jobs pay well, and on the off chance that's not what you're looking for, well, I can't really help you then. We've been in New Atlantis for a very... with lots of infrastructure already in place, ample storage, and it's had the unintentional, but not unwelcome, side effect of weeding...
Okay, don't care.
The Trade Authority appreciates your visit.
Thought it was an official thing, because they call themselves the Trade Authority? No, illegitimate business. Like we're a smuggling operation.
That's just how things are.
Yeah, I just don't think Bethesda knows how to create an actual interesting location anymore that makes you want to like check it out.
So bad.
This is like a seedy underground location, but I just don't feel any like desire to look through it. Is this another one of those things I can like sneak and steal through? Yep. I could totally swipe that.
Stuff is the cheat. Absolutely.
This game just looks boring. I mean, it is. But when it goes wrong, that's when it gets good. Took me a while, but I found the direct quote from Snow Crash, and once the lens was finally exposed, pure geometric equation made real, so powerful and vulnerable at once. People could only think it was like nuzzling through skirts and outer... Okay, I remember that line, but yeah, that's just how the writer likes to describe things. It's not that uncommon. He's actually just more turned on by technology.
Watch your back out there.
Snow Crash is that one with hero protagonist? Yep, I've apparently got quite a few people now reading it in chat. Disappear when they try to get on the elevator, huh? They spawn in behind. What the fuck? How many people are. What? Anyone else? That's a lot of people, invisible people. Snake! There's like four people in the elevator. They're wearing an octo. Oh, Bethesda, you're so random. You gonna disappear too? Elevator of holding. The Clown Nova. You can fit so many people inside of it, chat. It's actually very efficient.
Been up there, huh? Space?
If you're in the market for art,
must be cool.
Shh! Are you crazy? Keep your damn voice down. Yes, yes. Just hand it over. You've held up your end of the bargain. Our transaction is complete, so I'll be on my way. Take care, and let's not talk about this again.
I remembered his name.
Okay, more money. That's all I wanted.
Back to it.
No.
Okay, we have one more side quest we've picked up. Access secure storage.
The hauler from Sidonia, the one that got his ship blown up by the Crimson.
It would be great if Bethesda explained the random people fading in and out saying to them. I mean, might as well. They might as well just like go with all the bugs and like come up with lore reasons for it. It'd actually be more immersive that way. So do we just not have drive cars or any type of like land vehicle in any at all in the future? Because this is like one giant walkable city, isn't it? Once we like left Earth, we decided to leave the cars behind and walk everywhere that isn't space travel. How much money do I have right now? Okay, we're at 49,000. I also don't use phones for the most. Yeah, I've noticed that. It's a weird future, but that's the design. Chat, weirdly enough, I kind of want to play Star Citizen now and compare the two games. I want to compare one unfinished game to another unfinished game. And see which one comes out better.
Hey, this really isn't a good place for civilians to be hanging around. There's something I can help you with?
Yeah, I can't really just let you in there.
The answer's still no. I'm glad you understand the position I'm in here. I'm still willing to talk.
All right, look, don't tell anyone I did this for you. I lose my job over it.
I don't know how I won that, but all right.
I had nothing to do with this.
This is an American colony where massive family trucks. Yeah. Where's the space SUVs?
All right, make it quick, will you?
You got this game mixed up with Star Citizen. Honestly, Star Citizen, for all of its faults, definitely looks better than this game in almost every way. It's like Star Citizen is actually what this game is trying to be, but it's actually like built off, you know, better technology. Alright. Still no fights or action. Well, we're just doing like really short side quests here on this safe planet, so yeah, there wouldn't be any fighting here. But I'm gonna like build a new spaceship after I turn this in, and then we're gonna go somewhere where there will be fighting, hopefully. Yeah, my spaceship is just a little bit not very strong right now. I was getting my ass kicked by some bounty hunters the other night. Didn't want to go into space again until I get that taken care of. Star Citizen has technically been released. Hasn't technically, well, it's in early access. You can actually play it and do a lot of stuff in it right now. It's not a finished game. And well, who knows if it ever will be. But yeah, I am kind of interested in playing that now, just to compare the two. What's up, Mike? How you doing?
Yes, what?
I don't want to sound desperate, but any luck finding my cargo? Hey there, new guy. Good to see you again. Can I get you something?
Oh, no way. You really got it?
I probably don't want to know what you did to get this.
I have also seen some people make some really good content off Star Citizen. No one died getting this.
I certainly hope not. This is a huge deal to me, but it's not worth either of us murdering over. Well, look, I can assure this will all be worth it in the end. Matter of fact, I'm going to let you have the first ever sample. On top of that, you get free drinks. Not like unlimited free drinks, but you want a little pick-me-up now and then? I got you covered. I need some time to work on what comes next. But this was the difficult part, I think. Really? Thank you so much.
Okay. Good.
Catch you later.
Like, you'd go insane if you had to live in this city with its boring architecture. Yeah, it is kind of like, eh. I mean, I guess that's what they're going for. It is like a space, maybe it's like a city built really quickly, but it doesn't really look like a city to me. All right, I think my ship, yeah, it's time to build a new ship, chat. Actually, what is my current objective? Vladimir, travel to a, you know, I guess we'll do the empty nest. My buddies and I are going to get on Star Citizen and either become guns for hire or become space miners. I mean, hey, it's got a multiplayer angle too, right? You're right. Haven't played Starfield in a bit. Is it getting good? It's the same as it has been. It's still pretty derpy. This is where I build my ship.
Anything I can help you with? Need some work done?
I'd like to view and modify my ships. So, actually, what ships do you have for
sale? I'm sure you can find something you like.
What do you got, buddy? Okay, that's kind of expensive. Actually, where do you see the price? Because that's just how much money he has on him. Ooh, I like that one. That one looks good. Probably. Like, where's the price for it, though? I don't see a price. I just see a purchase button. Like, this is my money, and this is the amount of money he has, but I don't see a price for the ship. Value? Where do you see that? Now? Oh, wait, it only costs that much? It's that cheap? It can't be just 2,200, right? There were guns in this place that cost more than that. Wow, these are really cheap ships. That's only for the shield generator? Wait, what? Okay, wait, you gotta buy each piece individually? Unselect a system on the left. Okay, now you see the value of them. Okay, that makes a bit more sense. Okay, I guess I'm not buying it. Okay, that one's technically affordable. It's actually not that much better than my current ship, though. It just has more... Wait, is this comparing it to my current ship, or what? I'm not sure. God, even this is fucking ridiculously confusing. Why does it want... Like, what? You can buy individual parts from it like this? That doesn't make any... Whatever. Yeah, this one is affordable. Be nice if I could like look through it before I buy something though. But this one doesn't look like it's better than what I currently have based off stats, so I guess we'll just try to build one or like upgrade my current one.
Sure, have at it.
Yeah, so we'll do that. We'll upgrade it. Let's see. Well, it's this ship is only currently worth 7,000. All right, so shield. Let's upgrade that. Ship upgrade mode allows you to make improvements to your ship without needing to worry about where modules would be placed. Some upgrades may have level or skill requirements. Multiple upgrades can be made and their costs will be added to the end of the session. Okay, so this will give me one extra tick of shield, huh? Is that doing anything? It feels like it's not buying it. Okay, maybe it did. I don't know. Like if I click on it, it makes a big dramatic sound, but your ship depreciated really quick. It's just like cars. So you would think clicking on this is how you buy it, but I don't think that's what's happening here. You select your upgrades, then when you exit the screen, it charges you for it. Oh, holy fuck, they don't know what they're doing, how they do this, do they? Just why? Why wouldn't you? Why would you make it that way? Alright, so I want that. Maybe upgrade my cannon? Or my laser? Here we go. Well, I need to upgrade my engine probably more than anything else. But is engine what gives... Okay, but upgrading my engine, would that give me overall more power to put into the other categories? Is that how that works? Or what? Or does that just make me go faster? Reactor? Okay, reactor. Okay, I guess that'll give me two extra ticks of reactor power. Is there any good reason to update this ship, or you're just fast traveling? You do get into fights, and that is the main reason. Alright, that gives me two extra ticks and I can add onto it, so we can use those to like upgrade the mauler to do some more damage. Or the missile launcher. A suppressant. It'd be nice if it tells me what the weapon does. It doesn't matter if your engine has maximum pip potential if you don't have the pips to invest it in. I mean, that's what I'm looking for, but I can't help but their system is convoluted and stupid. Like, it doesn't even tell me what these do. It's just got some stats down there, like on like a text description. Like, what is a suppressor? Is it like, it's not a silenced like space weapon. It can be. Disruptor electron beam. Guess we can try that. Like, I think that, you know, I have the Mahler auto cannon on right now. Yeah, so Mahler auto cannon is what I currently have. Okay, that's more missile. Should I go with this? You know, we'll go with the suppressor or whatever. We could get the newer. I guess that's a better missile launcher. Probably have the Atalpa. Sure, why not? And I don't think they have any new engines for him to use. Or another that, so I can't upgrade that. Or the grav drive. Or the reactor either, I don't think, can I? Or was that a door? Whatever. Alright, I think that's it. So I just back out of this now and it will pay it. Okay, that is so weird. Alright, there went a bunch of money. Wait, it doesn't... Wait, I have to... It moved into my cargo? I want to modify my... My ship is ugly? I don't care. So wait, how do I put them on? Okay, maybe... Okay, then, no, that's the ones I bought. Okay, they're there. Alright, it's my new weapon. Bought some new weapons.
Assistance.
Dark Souls 2 is on sale on Steam. It's time to visit Dranglik. I think I'm good. I'm good right now. I've always heard that one's a bit shit, and I've already played plenty of those. You know, I'm like little Souls now. You love the ship building here? So far, it's been an awkward experience for me.
If you're ever thinking to yourself, I could really listen to Barrett's dulcet voice right now. Then instead of dreaming about me, stop by and say hello, okay?
Hello.
Yow! What?
Dad, can I have
that's,
a pet?
That's how we say it to my people.
I want a starship, Cora. That's
I'm fine.
Starships don't always mix so well.
Aw, come on, please. I need somebody to talk to while I'm on the
ship.
Look
at that
myself.
Smile of like, man. Miscalculated my, that friendliness.
We'll see you come down.
Why are you trying to kill Bear? Because they can't. Look, in a world where your NPCs are immortal, why wouldn't you attack them left and right? You can't blame me for that. You can't die. There's no consequences to my actions. Oh, I think this looks different now, doesn't it? Or maybe it's the same. Or is it, okay, whatever. Oh, shit, didn't mean to put that in there. Put this iron away. We'll take the sword with us. Guard just shot his buddy. Yeah, but like I said, why wouldn't you? Can you honestly give me a reason not to, chat, when there's no consequences? Here, I'll do it again just for fun.
Uh-oh. Ah, come on!
It just...
Yikes! Watch it! It'll heal!
Now, put a band-aid on it.
We'll try to keep out of your hair while we're en route. Bye.
Got my attention, Captain.
Dad and I will be riding passenger with you. The most boring job in space travel. I want to fly my own ship and go all over the place. Like you and Dad, really.
Feel his hand. Maybe we get it, we do his quest line.
Not as crazy as your travels. I thought Dad's were exciting. But yours? Brr. I read.
You gonna create a new character for Cyberpunk DLC or not? No, I'll just use the one I have.
But he said I have to be respectful on your ship.
The nice voice crack I had there, by the way.
Things if you ask. Hint, hint. You can ask. I promise I'll be good. It's the best. I met another kid my age who hadn't been on a starship once. Not even once. Same boring old planet for like years. She didn't even know how to replace a phase manifold. Can you imagine? Yup. I've been his co-pilot since I was old enough to read a map. He lets me fly sometimes, and fix things aboard, and use the intercom, and everything! I just have to promise not to complain about having to stay aboard the ship when we're somewhere dangerous. Dad says when I'm older, he'll teach me how to use a pistol, and once I'm a good enough shot, I can go with him anywhere! I can't wait to get older.
Well, they didn't even give children, like, I'm injured, Yola. At least with the adults, they give, like, animations. Weak. Kind of a weak developer. Meanwhile, in Baldur's Gate 3, I can chuck gnome children, or like, you know, like, tiefling children over, like, edges of cliffs. Pathetic. Actually pathetic. Have some balls, video games. Alright, let's get flying. Sure there's gonna be a mod. Of course there's probably already a mod, but just like a mod doesn't explain away why Bethesda can't do some of this shit themselves. Meanwhile, you have Makarov at the airport with his friends mowing down kids left and right. Yeah, plenty of animations. Some developers are just braver than others. What? Is that too far away? Unexplored route. Oh, okay. So what, I gotta go here first, then go there? You have not explored every system along this route. Try jumping to a closer system. Okay. Next Bethesda game is going to be so streamlined and simplified, the game chooses everything for you, dialogue, weapon, I mean... You think they'll... Well, one, it's still got... I'm assuming the next one will be Elder Scrolls, and it'll... I want people to be prepared to be disappointed, because it's going to be... There's no going to be no improvements, all right? It's going to be the same. Yeah, this is an interesting world. I want to scan it. Got a deserted UC garrison and an autonomous Dogstar factory, and that's it. Assuming that's the Dogstar factory. Oh yeah, we should go ahead and like... Oh shit. What are you doing? Get back in the seat. Fuck is a Dogstar? Mm-hmm. I swear to God, I'm just hitting Alt and then like trying to like go to my like... My systems. I don't know why it keeps getting up out of the seat. Your alt key got peed on. I'm wondering if that's what did it. Yeah, I think. Did Dex break my alt key by peeing? I might have to use the other alt key. Alt keys are like the kidneys of your keyboard, chat. You got two of them. Have you ever thought of it that way before? Like, oh, you got two of them for a reason. Don't use it. Yeah, I wasn't using you. I'm trying to, like... Like, how... What was it? You hit, you hold Alt and then use the left and right keys to, like, select your systems, right? Like, neither of my Alt keys are actually making the... Let me, like, switch systems right now. Like I can't move it any. You can use the arrow keys. Okay, there we go. Okay, that works too. All right, so we got. It's like. Actually, how did I use the grab drive when I had no power to it? Interesting. You divert power automatically when you use that. Okay. Need to start peeing more on your belongings so Dex doesn't mess with it. Obviously, that's how that works. I'm here to ask because you are one of the few I can trust. 1 out of 10, how's the game so far? I'll be perfectly honest with you, since you came here expecting an honest answer and you gave me such a kind statement. I would not rate it highly. It's a frustrating mess of a game. Also, it just feels old. Nothing in the game feels like fresh to me. Like if you've played any other Bethesda game, I can't think of a single thing that you do in this that you haven't done in a different game from them or another game that's done it better. There's perplexing design choices everywhere that are just very user-unfriendly, in my opinion. The UI is a mess. None of the characters so far have, like, felt interesting or alive, even. They all just feel a little hollow and dead inside, like I'm in Utah. What is the story about? So far, the story is find alien metal. That's it. We haven't been, made aware of any other point of the story, but we just need to find alien metal. But also, thank you for checking out my stream, Dorian. Glad you trust me with that kind of thing. But honestly, at this point, only get it if you really want to, like, play mods with it, because those will be where you probably have a lot more fun, as well as doing, like, side quests, I guess. Unobtainium? Might as well be. Yeah. They just don't call it that. So, it is essentially what I expected it to be in every single way. It's just another, like, mid-level Bethesda game like they all are. Outside of Morrowind. Would you like this game better if it cost $40? Well, I would like every game better if it was cheaper. There's not a single game I can't think of that would be that wouldn't be improved by being cheaper to buy.
Scan complete. Go ahead and land.
It's like there's... Honestly, I would say wait for Star Citizen to be finished. That's probably going to be a better game if they can ever finish it, because that's pretty much what this game wants to be, but it's just too old of technology. So here, yeah, chat, we all make a blood pact. We all wait for Star Citizen to be actually finished. Then we can have the space game we've always wanted. To be honest, after I played the Mass Effect trilogy, it's really hard to exceed that. As always, you were a blast to watch. Oh, well, thank you. I will hopefully have some more videos out for you very soon. Probably now you're going to find some ancient alien race, accidentally turn on some kind of beacon leading to them invading the galaxy. You're going to spin Starfield 2 fighting the invading force. Usually, well, part of you were there is probably correct. However, the whole idea of this leading into a direct sequel is likely not the case. Usually, Bethesda does not make their games that way. I can at least say that in praise of them. They usually, each game is its own plotline and storyline that finishes in one go. Like Elder Scrolls, each individual Elder Scrolls is its own unique storyline and doesn't have like in the next, you gotta buy the sequel to finish it up. So I don't think that'll be the case. Star Citizen, yeah, never. We can always dream, all right? We can always dream. We should probably scan this place. And we're going to Aquila City. Space, Texas, here we come. Star Citizen is myth. Who would agree? To a degree, I mean, it is playable right now. It's just like one of those early access games that it is the most well-funded early access game. And because of that, they just like, hey, what if we keep adding stuff? Someone who's pretty far into the story, there might not be a sequel to this based on what I've seen so far. I mean, if there is, it's very far away. It's not worth getting excited over. It'd be so far away, you'll probably have kids by then if you don't have them at this point in time. It really is space, Texas. Let me put two rounds into the back of her head for that joke.
Got a moment?
You know it's for the good of the world when she makes jokes like that. I can't kill her, I'll kill you. That's how it works.
We'll try to keep out of your hair while we're en route.
We're here. What are you talking about en route? This is where you wanted to go.
I just wanted to say thanks for the daring rescue back there. I had plans for Matsura, of course, but I appreciate the backup.
Wasn't the Star Citizen dev sued or something? I don't know. They have no shortage of money, so it doesn't really matter. Someone who's... The worst thing about Star Citizen, yeah, it's like it's been in development forever and there's no clear finish line. But the actual game there... at least claiming they're making does look like it might be fun once it's ever finished, if ever. Did you hear about the orca attacks on fishing ships? We suspect it's on porpoise. You know what? You had an interesting topic there that I had read about, but then you made a pun. Now I can't. Now I'm legally bound not to discuss it with you. So we can't kill these guys or have sex with them either. What kind of game is this? I know, right? Yeah, you can only kill bad people. Anyone the game has discerned is a bad person. Bethesda RPC fire two shotgun shells and no one... Actually, no, it's worse than that. If I shoot this guy, for instance, he will bleed and flinch and even get knocked to the floor. He can't die, though. But children are off limits. You can't do any damage to them.
I could.
He disliked that.
It doesn't feel right. You're part of the family now, and we take care of each other.
That's what your boss tells you when you ask for a raise.
It's good to be part
of a family here at the old McDonald's.
Part of something.
Chad, has your boss ever told you that you're like a family when your workplace?
So many things can go wrong.
God, that is the most insufferable thing to ever hear a manager say.
Trust is important. That's why I've been in Constellation so long.
It's like, oh, you're just like trying to be a cult leader, aren't you?
Hey, if you have time, I've been thinking about some things. Wanted to talk to you about it.
I just talked to you.
Yes?
God, Bethesda, stop.
Hey, Dusty. If you're ever thinking to yourself, I could really listen to Barrett's dulcet voice right now.
Chad, has anyone kept track of how many times he has said this exact same line?
Stop by and say hello, okay?
I literally just talked to him and he's like trying to entice me into another boring conversation.
Hello. Hello, Captain. I will follow behind you.
It'll be better information than, you know, better companion than Barrett. That's what you get when you keep repeating yourself, like my dulcet tones. Motherfucker, I am a dulcet toned individual, not you.
How can I be of service, Captain? Yes, Captain.
I want to see if I can get, like, the space Texan in my party. I don't know if he needs to be here. I think he needs to be here.
Hello, Captain.
Something for me?
Actually, where'd the space cowboy go? Is he in the bathroom? Where's your dad, honey?
Don't worry. Any bad bye.
Okay, whatever. You weren't that annoying. You can come with me.
Yeah. I'm right behind you.
I'm blind? Possibly. I don't see him anywhere. There's like the guy that's a different guy. That's the guy I just told to stop following me. And then the robot actually got into the ship somehow, but the other guy isn't out here. He's already outside. Ooh.
Have things for you.
To be fair, I didn't walk any further than this area, so of course I couldn't have seen him.
Here. You ready? Because once we get started, I'm going to be riding your tail till this is over. There's something you should know up front. I'm a Ko. As in Solomon Ko, first man on Aquila. That tail I mentioned before, the one I think is connected to an artifact, it's something of a family legend. After Planetfall, Solomon spent years mapping Aquila. And he found a tiny little patch of nothing on his sensors. The kind of nothing an artifact produces. He called it the Empty Nest. Said it was a place even the wildlife of Aquila wouldn't go. Solomon's maps are locked up tight in the local Gal Bank. We'll be heading there.
Okay. You just took a nap this late in the day? Oh, she's headed back to the ship. Okay, will you follow me then?
Here. This is for you. Well, I see your parents didn't skimp on your P's and Q's. I spotted it on our last planetary foray. All part of the service.
This is the only time we've been out together. What are you talking about, our last planetary foray? Like, literally the first time we've gone together anywhere.
Hey, I'm gonna pick things up one way or the other. I'll keep my eyes peeled. Who knows? Check in with me now and again and I might find more.
Thanks for the cobalt. You found me a rock.
We gotta get to that vault in Galbank. Goodbye.
I thought you might like this. Here's a rock. You skipped some dialogue, so now you're suddenly been traveling at... Okay, why is he not following me? Okay, okay, now he's following me. He's just like waiting for you. Alright. Or is he? Whoa! What the fuck? He turned into like a vampire. Every time they do that, it's always like bizarre looking.
That's not a problem. And you're springing for the new reactor? It's still under manufactured warranty.
Yes. Can I get an invoice?
What'd you need one of those for?
Corporate policy.
Is it okay if I just write it on
this
pen?
Game's been in production for like
as
8 years.
As long as it's written and signed,
yes, but that doesn't really mean anything.
Bread.
It will never show 8 years worth of effort.
Hey, what can I do for you? Got anything you need to offload? Trade Authority is always buying. Kiosk right here for you.
You have any like
okay,
new parts
no
I can like equip? Really need your new reactor, Ivel. And they still don't have one. I could upgrade the shield, though. Yeah, we'll just upgrade the shield. Feels like dog meat as AI follows you where you were looking instead of where you're headed, really. The engine is being held together by duct tape and a spark and spite. I thought you meant like Sprite. You know what? Sprite can be sticky if you like pour it on something and let it dry. That's probably a more accurate term of what's holding this engine together.
Take care of yourself.
Hold it. By order of Marshal Daniel Blake, I need to inform you we've got some trouble at Galbank. Folks might be in danger, so you may want to steer clear.
Never a dull moment around here.
I know you. You're Sam Coe.
If any ship battles,
glad
yes.
To have another free star
they're not that impressive.
Afraid your information is a couple years out of date.
People are in danger, then I want to help. What's the trouble?
Well, all I know is there was an attempted bank robbery and things went sideways. You'd have to ask the marshal if you want the whole story. Not usually, but he took charge of the situation because the bank robbers are part of the Shaw gang. The marshal's had a lot of experience dealing with
camera
the gang,
snaps between
so
characters are so
shots.
Jarring. You're right. That's another one of those things that, you know, Bethesda... It's so weird. Bethesda has to be aware of all the stuff people make fun of them for, but they just will not change any of it. They're just like, yeah, whatever. And like, these like camera pans into people's faces, they're so abrupt and jarring and weird. They've been sticking with it ever since Oblivion.
I guess that'd be the Marshal's call. Frankly, it ain't going well. Looks to be a stalemate. Maybe a little outside help would do some good.
Well, I doubt those robbers are gonna let us leisurely peruse the Galbank vault. We better see if we can help move the situation along.
So, kill them?
You stay where I can see you, Marshal. Everyone stays in front of the building, you got me? If you make a move toward the building, a hostage dies.
Yeah, I've come across you before.
Well, look who it is. How are the settled systems treating you? Make any enemies yet? Choosing to act is what puts you in conflict with others. It's not about how pure the intentions are.
Who's the edgy follow? I don't know. We've come across him before.
Once you start making a real impact on the universe, there's always more and more people who end up on the losing side of your decisions. Someone always gets hurt. Now you sound like one of the factions. I'm sure both the United Colonies and the Free Star Collective think they're making things better. But that didn't stop them from going to war. I guess that's just the nature of things, isn't it? People start by thinking they're doing the right thing. And then your version of what's right collides with someone else's. But it doesn't last. That's my point. Even if everyone's
benefiting, Jim, have a good night, man.
Some people are benefiting
more. Might not be able to make streams this week. That's okay.
And then eventually someone thinks it's time to rebalance the scales. Better to just let people be. A single person achieving their own ends is at least honest. Helping people is just another form of control. There I go again. I was in danger of waxing philosophical last time, and now I'm knee-deep in it. I should stop while I'm ahead. I'll catch you around.
I hope this guy ends up being the villain who just, like, follows us around because we keep running into him. I'm glad in the future, like 300 years from now, we, like, everything is reverted to, like, the 1800s and you just have, like, a general store. With a few shelves.
Everyone needs supplies. I get all kinds in here. Here, browse to your heart's content.
What do you have, sir? Whole lot of nothing in pack. I might buy a med pack or two.
I think
we'd get a mall that encompasses a mall-sized planet. You're right. Capitalism demands it. Nose grub paperweight. This area has me remembering that one place from Skyrim where you show up and there's like a murder takes place right in front of you.
Journey around here is
you need to stand back now.
Sounds like you could use some help, partner.
I don't mean to be rude, but I don't know you. Now please, stand back.
Aquila City at its finest, I see. Never a dull moment.
Well, I'll be damned. Sam Cole. Been a long time. I won't hold my breath about you being here to take the badge again. Listen, Sam, just so you know, I don't blame you for how it went down.
Hey, Dorian, thank you for the tier one. You might get is that your first time subscribing?
Thanks. I appreciate you saying
so. It was a special moment, isn't it?
But I figure some of that reception is owed.
It's the only interesting city in the game. Yeah, I guess so, maybe.
It seems you got a situation. My friend here may be the answer you're looking for.
It feels more like a Skyrim location, I guess.
I'll trust your judgment on this one. Some folks from the Shaw gang tried to rob the place, but they got spotted by a guard.
Hope you have persuasion perk. Honestly, I'd rather like shoot my way through this.
They took everyone inside hostage, and now they're keeping a watch so we can't move against them.
Hours don't usually met, so I watch YouTube videos. Yeah, I need to actually upload another batch of YouTube streams, the YouTube stream archive. But I thank you for like checking me out live. I honestly. I'm thinking of, like, maybe by next year, like, changing up some of my streaming practices and, like, including maybe even a webcam and streaming at an earlier time. But I haven't decided on it yet. And also doing other types of streams besides gaming stuff. I might start doing some just chatting streams. Have they made any demands?
They won't talk to me. Say they don't trust the badge. They want a neutral negotiator. In other words, they didn't have a plan for this, so they're stalling while they come up with one. All right, I'm willing to allow that. But a few things first. Say what you have to, but whatever they ask for, there's no way in hell I'm giving it to them. Also, there are lives at stake, so don't get cavalier. Find out what they want, and then report back to me.
Take it slow and steady. Look for every opportunity to de-escalate. You got this.
Thanks for the pep talk.
You in the bank. I'm sending in a negotiator, so don't shoot.
Hands where I can see him, and don't try nothing.
Don't just talk. Well, I will talk, but I'm hoping it devolves into shooting. I like how these people are don't clear out the bar next to it, just let this lady finish her drink. Even if the shooting starts. How you doing today, man?
You're the negotiator, huh? If you think you're just gonna walk up here and get us to surrender, you're dead wrong. It's Jed Bullock.
Hi, Jed. I'm Dardigan.
Well, ain't you polite. So tell me, stranger, how do I know you're gonna deal straight with us?
Because you're not the only one who's had trouble with the law. That's right, I did get arrested earlier.
I heard that. Okay, so let's talk.
Must be something you want. What's the condition of the hostages?
They talk to. About everything. But as much as we'd like to, none of us has shot one yet.
Look at this future technology, chat. Not even a touch screen anywhere on it.
We want to guarantee a safe passage to the spaceport and a ship. We'll drop the hostages off somewhere safe in the system. After that, we'll radio back where they are and the Marshal and his crew can come and get them.
How much can you realistically get robbing a bank? I don't think you can get much if you rob a bank even these days. This is like old-timey crime.
Oh hell, the Free Star Rangers have got ships. They could give us one of them. This whole damn job's gone wrong. It was supposed to be just a quick hit. Clean and simple, you know?
People make fun of Tesla for having a screen that replaces a physical gear shit. I don't know, I don't really pay too much attention to Tesla.
Because my guys...
But yeah, I do know they just have a big touchscreen.
I don't know how much longer we can last.
By the streaming schedule, lately all these amazing or noisy games coming out, best time to do it is now, as I always say. Yeah, but I'm also a little busy this, like I've got a trip coming up at the end of this month. And then possibly another one at the end of December for like holiday stuff. So I'm not sure how it'd be a good time to do that at that point, but... Next year should also be pretty good for video games. Not too late in this.
What do you mean? You have to believe me. We never meant to take hostages. It's up to the marshal to make sure the hostages don't get hurt. If the hostages die, it'll be the Marshal's fault for not taking us seriously. Nah, it's too late to back out now. We're seeing.
All right, looks like we gotta kill them.
You go tell the Marshal to get that ship ready so we can all walk away from this thing without anybody getting
You're
hurt.
Here hating this game, hating the game. Am I hating the game? No, I'm actually enjoying myself just laughing at it. Like, why would I hate a game that has a your infinite motion device in it, in this random place? Look at that. Free energy right there, chat. Like, free infinite energy. This thing is not stopping moving. Look, it's a fucking miracle. Fusion energy? Nah, you just got this. Perpetual motion, baby. You actually like this game? I'm not huge on it. I'm just here to like laugh at it a bit and see what I can see.
Guys are scared. I can tell. I heard every word. He's talking too loud. Sign of fatigue. All that fear and exhaustion are taking a toll. They're not thinking straight. That puts us in a very precarious position.
Time for negotiation is over.
I appreciate your idealism, but there were only ever two ways this could end. You've already ruled out one of them, so that leaves us with only one option. We have to free the hostages.
Still better than Forspoken.
By taking out their captors.
I would agree,
problem
yes.
Is, they're keeping me and the guards inside.
Game is still better than High on Life. Is
if
it?
We try to move against them.
As cringy as High on Life was, at least it was just a straight up first person shooter. It wasn't trying to be like a life changing experience where like they promise you you explore an entire galaxy. It's just like a level by level shooter. It's just that Rick and Morty humor that isn't there for everyone. I could go in. I'm not part of your security force, so I might be able to catch them off guard.
You'd be willing to do that? You've got guts, that's for damn sure. I can't deny that you're right, though. They might not see
you
that
are
coming.
Incompetent at this job. You let a
now,
city do this.
I see two ways we can play this. You could ask to see the hostages. Once you're inside, you can make your move.
You hate Rick and Morty? I've actually never watched it.
I think you can take them out before they have a chance to respond.
You didn't buy the hype at all. I knew it would be a somewhat janky Bethesda. I mean, good on you.
There's also a back door. Most of their attention's focused out front here, so they may not be watching it as closely. This key should unlock.
Really like Bethesda games. For the most part, they get things right, even if not on purpose. I mean, Bethesda is more than just their open world RPGs. They also have other games that, like, they released like a DMC wacky clone just a few months ago. They've made some decent horror games with, like, you know, the two Evil Within games, even though those were without their flaws. Hey, honestly, weirdly, one of the games that I liked the most that was made with the Elder Scrolls engine was that Shadow over Innsmouth game, even though that was also a buggy mess that couldn't even be completed. But it's just that they're falling into the trap in that they landed on something that made them incredibly successful and rich with this format for their Elder Scrolls Oblivion. And they have not changed from it since Elders. They've just made slight differences here and there. Like, if you can play Elder Scrolls Oblivion, you've technically already played Skyrim. You've already played Fallout 3 and 4. And you've already played this. It is just more of that. Only with, like, change in scenery or, like, change from melee or melee, or if you say it, to like guns. There isn't a whole world of difference that you would expect. They're not the only developer that suffers from that, where they have like a particular type of game they just like try to slot everything into. Assassin's Creed for one. But it's just disappointing because it could be so much more. But it really requires them to like, one, they need a new engine, they need a new approach to how they make these games. They need to stop making such buggy messes. It's just not acceptable. I can say I appreciate their dedication to the modding community. Few games these days do that as much as they do, of allowing you to just mod the hell out of a game. Some actually go out of the way to make it difficult to mod, but I can give them props for that. It's one of the reasons their games are so popular, actually, is that they just become a big modding big modding scene springs up around it, because you can make all sorts of other types of experiences with it. Like, their entire games, that they're like things that started off as like a mod for an Elder Scrolls game that turned into their own individual game. All right, let's get them to let us in.
What'd the marshal say? We have a deal?
Yeah. Skywind project is huge. There's a game recently about a time loop in like King Midas or something. I forget the name of it though.
Fine, but make it quick. Make a fair point.
This is the Freestar Collective. I've been carrying a weapon as a way of life out here. You know that. You got me outnumbered. Wait, where'd that other option go? Okay.
That's true. If you tried something, we'd take you out real quick. Alright, fine. But if you so much as look at me, I'm sending you straight to the morgue. There. Door's unlocked.
Hey, and I leveled up. Look at that. In that persuasion, we also completed the challenge for it. Unlock this rank to increase the skill. I'd rather spend this point somewhere else. Ship cargo holds up. Wait, my ship cargo hold has capacity as well? The fuck? My ship. Well, I guess it makes sense that my ship would have an encumbrance, but. Ugh. About to do some like killing, so we probably don't want this. Does bigger ship mean bigger storage? I believe so. Now, what gun do I currently have? Okay, seems like it's going to be mainly close range stuff, so make sure we have this ready. Have I given up on Armored Core? I don't know yet. But right now I'm playing this and I have Baldur's Gate 3 tomorrow. So we'll see when I... And I still have to even finish, like, fucking Legend of Dragoon, man. I've got a lot of things to play right at this moment in time.
They're in the vault, down there. Hey, the negotiator's coming down to check the hostages.
Space Texans, you know?
So damn tired. I just want to get out of here.
This guy is stabbed awkwardly holding that axe, huh? Alright. Go down there and check. You make a video on Baldur's Gate 3? I don't think I could. Just... It'd be hard to make a video that everyone would, like, that could land on, like, the general play experience for everyone so they, like, recognize scenes that they were in. Because there's so many ways things can go, or even not go, in that game based on your actions.
Shut up! You're wasting my time and I'm sick of it!
I'm gonna count to five, and if you ain't told me what I wanna know, I'm gonna blow your head off.
I'm telling you the truth. Please, I have a wife.
Five? Four? Three, two, one.
Get back here.
You endangered a hostage.
I thought I heard.
You all right, sir? I'm gonna take this money off your hands.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm saving your life.
Please, tell me this is going to end soon.
I should have filled out that will when I had the chance.
This is going to end badly. I just know it.
Hold it right there. You're in all kinds of trouble.
What the fuck? What? Hold up. I'm here saving hostages and they sent in these guys because I stole some cred sticks? and he's in kissing distance with me. They sent me in here to kill these motherfuckers. I kill some of them, and then I'm looking around, I grab two cred sticks, and one of the hostages saw me steal it, and that brought in the cops to come arrest me. Just how you were being naughty. You know what? Fuck it.
Why do I always get the dumb ones? Don't hurt them.
Fuck it. You know what? All of you died. Have a mind. No one lives. I am the criminal now, apparently, according to this game. Like, how does it... Alright, let's just, like, jump on a mine. Can't even die. Who are you? What are you doing? What the fuck? What the fuck? He's so mean. Like, this is fun. Oh, video game. Oh, you know, I take back everything. I fucking love this game. 10 out of 10, best game ever. Like, just some random dude walked in.
Where's the good stuff, old man? I know you got something valuable stashed away in here. Don't you lie to me now.
Oh.
You don't understand. The vault is for storing priceless heirlooms and relics from Aquila City's proud history.
Shut up! You're wasting my time and I'm sick of it! I'm gonna count to five. And if you ain't told me what I want to know...
You're mine!
This time I'm not gonna steal the cred sticks.
Oh, this is pointless.
Because, you know, I know that's a terrible crime.
Please. Don't let me die.
Somebody cover me! Damn it! You won't get away! Hear me?
Here comes the fun.
Never should have trusted you!
Bye-bye.
I admire your bravery, kid, from coming at me with an axe when I'm using a shotgun. That might be worth selling. Really, they won't mind if I take the credits off the robbers, right? You've only heard me laugh like that? Yeah, well, usually only when a game breaks in a hilarious way. Or just something tickles me the right way when you hear a laugh like, you know, just a good old cackle come out of me. What we got back here?
Wait, you know that's not ours.
Does it fucking... Game, why do you care so much about me stealing? Perfectly fine. These are the biggest air vents in video game history, by the way. I mentioned that the other night, but you don't even have to crouch down in them. These are not air vents, these are just hallways. Yeah, let's go see if we can talk to the people downstairs. Last time I heard you laugh like that was when you played AI Dungeon. Like I said, you must not have been here when I was playing that Forspoken game a few months back. That game got so busted that I couldn't help but like just like ugly laugh.
Thank
now
you so much.
I have two
now, will they see me and call the cops if I take these? Oh sweet, one of them bent. Okay. Alright, there we go. Let's go report mission well done. Remember when it crashed, but you could still play it? I know, that was so... I've never seen that, and I probably will never see it again. The bees in Tenchu made you low. Oh yeah, the bees. Your laugh sounds like a literal jester. It's so contrasting to your monotone voice, and I think it's hilarious. Well, are you the guy that got set on fire and walked? You are. But I am a clown, so it makes sense that I sound like a jester. All right, people, stand down. I've murdered everyone inside, except for the people who weren't supposed to die.
Seems we've got a little excitement on our hands.
I heard the fight. The hostages, are they safe?
Is that so? Shame it had to come to that. But you got the job done and saved lives. Here, you've more than earned this. You got us out of a tough spot, and you did it with courage that's not common. As a matter of fact, you might just be Freestar Ranger material. If you're interested, head on over to the Rock.
You have any settlements for me to protect?
She handles the new recruits.
All right. Now that lives aren't coming, let's get back in Galbag, see if we can get those maps.
These days, I hardly
see another settlement. Need your help. Can he be our version of that? There's gotta be like a Preston Garvey character in this game as like a reference, correct? There has to be. Imagine this guy arrested you. Who did he send in to actually like do that before? It looked like they were like high-tech security people.
Well, that was fun. I was so scared.
It's like, we have a hostage situation in there. Also, we have a report of petty, like, you know, shoplifting. Send in the SWAT team. We can't let this stand.
Ashta, if you're looking for a weapon, I've got you covered. Just so you know.
Elegance. Shattering, breaking through even the strongest armor. That looks like a rip-off model of, like, the blaster from Blade Runner to a degree, with a few extra things added onto it. Oh, it's a clown gun. Nova Light? Is that a light particle beam pistol? I think I just rather find my weapons rather than buy them. Wait, why is this space dude looking like he's like from the 1600s, like fur trapper?
Okay, we'll take it from here.
Nice job.
Cowboy Bebop. It's a shame we've never gotten an actual good Cowboy Bebop game.
Mostly. Still feels a little weird though. I guess I'm not used to having the tube out. But it's nothing that would keep me from getting back out there.
We need to give it more time.
What did you miss? We had a very interesting time in the bank. Where we like started killing the gang members, and then I picked up a cred stick, and that summoned in the SWAT team to come in and kill me.
Fine, fine. But you should know that I'm crawling the walls in here.
You just take it easy. Shouldn't be long now.
Well, hey there.
Some days it feels like if I stopped stitching people back together, the whole city would be a ghost town in a week.
Hiya.
got into a tussle with a Shaw gang.
Not supposed to happen. Well, yeah, it's a bit weird since they had like the entire bank surrounded by the posse. But me sent in to save them all. If I pick up a cred chip in front of the hostages report the crime, and they send in the SWAT team to pass the gang members to kill me. How Starfield messy, but in funny ways.
Yeah, of course. Everyone knows a thorologic tube is the right approach for that problem. Right now, not much of anything. Meanwhile, I've been trying to make myself useful. Reading that way, when I'm cleared for field duty.
Cool.
You're probably looking for Mary. The doctor can provide any supplies you might need.
Just waiting around.
Great.
Sorry, but I've got work. If you're hurt, the doctor can see to you.
What? You know that's illegal.
Not if they don't see it. Fuel piece? I can all my stuff is at the ship. Would you say Baldur's Gate 3 is the most free game to ever come out in the amount of choices it gives you? If it's not the most free, it is definitely up there. There aren't too many games that are quite that liberating to play.
What do you think you're doing?
It's harder for yourself.
Going too far this time.
You stole a med pack. Well, wait, are you not gonna arrest me? Even he's bored. He's like, this guy's supposed to like come up and engage you in a thing where he like demands you pay a fee or go to jail, but hey, if you're not gonna like stop me. The police just glitched out, chat.
You seen those ashed outside?
They sent in the cops and even they glitched out. He didn't even like arrest me. Fine, I'll take, you know what? Fine with me.
Just let me get in peace.
A year or two back, I shared a drink with Ron.
That's pretty crazy.
That man can drink.
Well, nobody ever accused those boys.
Wait, what kind of hospital is this? And has a bar over top of it. What the hell? I'm a little confused by that. So downstairs, clinic and like hospital. Upstairs, bar.
The mayor's all right.
Always with poker tables and shit. Makes sense. I mean, maybe they had limited space.
You should try Philbert's beer.
To say they work at the Rock.
You play a sci-fi RPG made by Larian if it had the same amount of freedom as Baldur's Gate 3? Hell yeah. I think their interest though is kind of like, you know, fantasy though. That's all they've ever made. Honestly, I like Baldur's Gate 3 so much. I technically already own Divinity 2, which is also a really great game from them. I might end up playing that at some point.
She's an angel. There you go.
Aid. He just sells alcohol and tapas.
You got some business with me?
I try and give a credit or two to the low house when I'm able.
I'm the hero of the Galbank hostage crisis.
Really? You must have impressed the marshal. I'm guessing he wants to recruit
alcohol
you, so
sold at a bar under the label of aid, though. And also, well, this is a hospital
Rangers
bar.
Ensure the safety and security of the Free Star Collective and its people. We might hunt down a fugitive, break up a smuggling operation, investigate a starship theft, or put some would-be bank robbers behind bars. Whatever needs doing to keep the people safe, we do.
Admirable.
Like most things that are worth doing, it ain't always easy. But do I think we make the Free Star Collective a little safer for everyone? Yeah, I do. I imagine you've got some questions. I'll answer anything I can.
Mm-hmm. What authority do the Rangers have?
Well, in theory, a Free Star Ranger can go anywhere in Free Star Collective space, even private property. But of course, it doesn't always work out that way. We also have jurisdiction over any local security when we're tracking a fugitive. I'll say right up front that if you're looking to get rich, this ain't the line of work for you. But yeah, we do get paid from time to time to help with expenses and such. Okay then. A word about myself. I'm in charge of making sure anyone that wants to be a Free Star Ranger is up to the task. That being said, the Marshal wouldn't send you here.
Hey, do you mind that I stole a med kit downstairs?
So, what's it gonna be? Are you ready to sign up with the Free Star Rangers?
Sure, partner.
Might be a good fit for you. The Rangers can do a lot of good.
Before I hand you a badge, I need to know you can handle the job. You helped out with the hostage situation, but sometimes people just get lucky. Tell you what, use the mission terminal and take one of the listed jobs. Your choice. Come back alive, and we'll talk about you joining up.
This is a terrible way of running a business.
Oh, got no lack of confidence, have you? Well, let's see if you back it up.
I don't think this is what I was supposed to do. This is like a random mission.
Good to see you.
Destroy the Crimson Fleet Captain and Nereon, huh? Well, actually, that works out for my other side quest, I guess. Continue looking through this place, though.
Welcome to the Rock. Diego Monroe, at your service.
Don't care. Yours. I can't talk to everyone, Chad. There's just too many NPCs.
We got a lot of bar. A lot of famous people visit Aquila. Pop a back of beer, you never know who you'll meet.
Chad, I have a question for you. What was, like, your favorite location or, like, town area from any, Bethesda game, or like
these
the other open world games. So, what was your favorite areas from stuff, from, say, like Skyrim, Oblivion, and Fallout 3 and 4? They usually had at least one good one per game, I feel. Like, for me, it was like the... obviously, I think Megaton was like the best city in Fallout 3. A lot of the other ones in it, I thought were just like, meh. Like, I did not like the city that was like a former aircraft carrier, since it was all corridors. But thankfully, it took me forever before I ever got to it. Sidith Mora and
Ranger
Vivek
Central.
City from... Oh, like, you like looking around for the, you know, the... What is it? The foreign quarter, I think it's called? The one is that you can never had to, like... You can never find your way around? Morrowind? Yeah, Morrowind, I guess, counts. Does the Dark Brotherhood lair in Oblivion count? Yeah, that counts. When I think of Oblivion, though, the only location I feel that I liked was, that town the vampire, you know, guy ran. I forget the name of it. Alright, main quest. In the unknown. Okay, let's go do that. Balclair, like I said, I don't remember the name of it. I just remember there was like a count who's like a vampire, and you can like, I like that place. I guess for Skyrim it would have been, well, Whiterun. Whiterun was like the classic, like, well-designed village in it.
I've had quite enough excitement for now.
You guys cleaned out the bodies fast.
I suppose I'll have to write a report about all of this.
Or maybe you didn't. You left one over here. Only played Skyrim and I can't remember any place that really stood out to me. Well, actually, when I think of one place in Skyrim that I was pretty impressed with is when you actually go into like one random cave and you come across this gigantic underground map of that's full of like glowing mushrooms and shit with its own like special areas. That was pretty awesome to me. I was like, oh, that, because I wasn't expecting it. And it's like an entirely like new underground world full of like all kinds of stuff to do in it. So that was pretty good.
Family has a few different deposit boxes secured in here, so let's look around. Here's a copy of the key. Okay, now remember, Solomon was from an earlier
generation. I also did like the snow elf area. For some reason, I remember spending a lot of time in the snow elf area, the zombie elves, wherever they were. I spent a lot of time doing that area, that general locations and stuff. Gold pyramid sculpture. No art lab. Snow elf sounds like something you call white girl. Well, in the world of like Skyrim, they were like devolved cave elves.
Jacob. Of course that old mule saw this coming. He's just a bitter old man, interfering in what's none of his business. You gonna be like this the whole way? Damn it. I was hoping to avoid the estate. Cora's gonna be so mad. We really gotta do this.
Yes.
Can't we just leave it? And why do you have to be so pushy, huh? Yeah, I know. I know, it's just... it's personal. Alright, fine. He's my dad, okay? We're not exactly on friendly terms. He probably figured I'd come for the maps at some point. Got ahead of me. Family business just wasn't something I wanted to get into, you know? God, that's the worst part. They're thick as thieves. Last thing I need is Jacob in her life. Let's leave it at that.
Thanks for opening up to me, Sam.
Yeah, well, sorry I'm such a pain about it. No forgiveness between me and my old man. It's, co-tradition. All right, shall we?
Okay. Got some Frank's Red Hot Sauce and I want something stronger. Yeah, I feel that's pretty mild. I actually do want to get some, like, really novelty, like, really hot stuff eventually, just so I can, like, be mean with it. Put it on stuff for people that I like. Here, have this. Have some chicken wings, man. Like every once in a while, you gotta surprise people, right? Keep them on their toes. So, what was on that note that I got? No, you and your friends were gonna come plunder your heritage at some point. You want those maps? You know where to find me. Also picked up a bunch of stuff, like Why was this in a vault? I guess we can sell some of it. You ever try ghost pepper sauce? I have done better. I have eaten a whole ghost pepper. Literally, I owe my career to eating a ghost pepper and filming a video of it. I would not be here on Twitch doing this right now, or like releasing like, you know, YouTube videos that is my full-time job, had I not spent 30 minutes of agony after like scarfing down, you know, well, a ghost pepper. As my first big successful video, actually. Big chat, that's all it takes. A little bit of luck. You just gotta be stupid. What's your favorite city in sci-fi? For me, it's LA from Blade Runner and Vegas from Blade Runner 2049. So you just love big Blade Runner, man. Favorite sci-fi city? Well, I would have said Blade Runner as well. But since you already taken that, I will go back to my favorite like novel that we were talking about earlier, Snow Crash. Which it takes place in LA, but it's a version of LA where after the government doesn't exist anymore, like every street and every like block is like its own separate like micronation with its own laws and culture. Combined with like the cyberpunk setting, so it's pretty cool. Didn't Kotaku do an article on you? They did several on me. But that was only after I started doing GameSense. My first successful video was not GameSense. And it was actually on a completely different channel than my current one. And also, Kotaku only covered me because I tricked them into covering me. I, like, set them up.
Gravity is a harsh mistress. And here, even more so.
For your 10-year anniversary, do a stream for eating a ghost pepper? Maybe I could. It would not be fun. It would not be fun. Maybe fun to watch, but I would be in agony. Ghost pepper videos, yeah, I did that. That was a bit before I started doing GameSense. Like a full year before, I think. You tricked them? I would release a video and then I would like... talk to Amira Wolf at the Low House, what was it? What I would do is like, Kotaku has like a tip email where you can send them tips about stories on the online and stuff you come across. So I would like release a video and then I would send them a tip email. Talking about, hey, I found this like video you guys might be interested in talking about. And I would also send them the tip email on Friday because they don't post articles on Saturday and Sunday. So if I could get them to like make an article on it and release it on Friday, it would be on their front page for like three full days until like Monday came around and pushed it off. So I did that for like my first couple batches of videos and I got them to like cover me like 4 or 5 times. But they also covered the ghost pepper video, and that was the same thing. I sent them like a tip about it. So yeah, you can actually look for me and like find articles there. What they say, there's like weird thing. Kotaku's a weird website. They report on just about anything for the clicks. So they think they'll get clicks out of it, they'll report on it. Like, hey, I can use that. Space Texas. Old school BuzzFeed, more or less, yeah. When are we gonna get Space West Virginia? We've gotten Space Texas too many times. I want wall, Space Appalachia.
Hostile are no joke. Even for us.
We need variety, goddammit. Any Space Ohio? I think that's the place we just came from, the other planet.
Well, well. Sam Cole finally decides to darken our doorstep again.
You know why I'm here.
Oh? And what's that? You come to your senses? Realize where you ought to be for once?
I ain't asking again.
You ain't asked once. Let's hear it. I want you to say the words about what's more important to you than family.
Okay, This was a mistake.
The only mistake I'm seeing here is you. Bringing your Constellation lackey here instead of my granddaughter. Come to help Sam loot his ancestry? You're not getting those maps. Full stop.
Let Sam say this one.
I got just as much right to those maps as anyone else in this family.
That's exactly right, Sam.
What about Space Florida?
We all share Solomon's legacy.
Since I'm here, let me ask you, what happened to Hogwarts Legacy? The hype died, and I mean died. You played, how fun was it? Well, I mean, it was a single player game, and there's only so much you can do in it. There's no multiplayer element. Every single player game eventually just like dies off a few months after release.
It's what you do.
So I'm not sure what you'd expect. What were you expecting? People just keep playing the game over and over again? I mean, it's actually not even that big of an open world game. It's on the small. Actually, that's probably its credit actually. So it was an alright game. I feel like it would have been better if it had focused more on the school rather than like the boring fields outside the school. That was a weird choice to me. Like Hogwarts was well done. But I would have actually made the game almost entirely set within Hogwarts, so I would have made that even bigger. And yeah, but for some reason, like, hey, wouldn't it be cool if you go to Hogwarts and then explore some empty ass fucking fields around it? So I didn't really agree with that direction. But overall, the game was like, I guess, about as good as you can make an open world Hogwarts game.
Give me a sec. All right, let's talk options.
I can look around. You mentioned his granddaughter, maybe.
No. I mean, this is no place for her, okay? The less time she spends with Jacob, the better.
Well, you didn't mind her coming along, and about her and Jacob getting along, isn't it?
Yeah. Like I said before, they're thick as thieves. Can you imagine what that bitter old mule would do to her head if she hung around more? I'd appreciate that.
I could speak to Jake. He might see reason. The maps have to be here somewhere. You distract him, I can look around.
Okay. That's not bad. Just, give me a minute to brace myself, okay? Round two with the old mule can be even worse than round one. Next time you talk to Jacob, tell him I want a word with him. That'll be our cue. You slip away and I'll keep him busy.
All right. So we'll do a preliminary look over before we do that. Game, but we could really use some help. UC is growing bolder, and you always had a way of negotiating around them, core, even through them. Keep the free star ahead. I'm asking you to come out of retirement. If you could work part-time or be a consultant, I'm sure we can agree what's fair compensation. Really need your help, old friend. Even if it's me grabbing you a beer at the Stone Root, so I could pick your brain. Thanks. Yeah, why do I have to, like, distract him when I can come down here without him, even caring? You distract him while I just, like... Okay. David Copperfield? The legend himself? What about California? Are you guys like thinking of like what state would make a good space setting now? I didn't know I was gonna kick off such a discussion on this. Which state has the longest coastline? Yeah, definitely Alaska. its entire, almost, it's basically almost its entire peripheral is, you know, coastline. I should probably use the scanner, actually. It probably doesn't even appear until you start talking with him, but hey. About Florida, wish I could do that more. Remember when Florida was fun? Only the beaches though, right? Like most of Florida is like swamp, and then you got like some expensive like real estate in the beaches and the islands. That's about it, right? How many doors does this guy need to lead outside? Yeah, I guess I gotta like talk to him before this will like spawn in. Or it's maybe it's behind that door. Yeah, it's probably behind that door.
Sam's Constellation lackey here to bother me again? Well, that's not your decision, is it? It's co-property by birthright. Stays here.
Okay.
You really believe that, don't you? I know all about your group's reputation. It's not what concerns me. Can't believe I'm saying this.
Well, that was easy.
But if they'll get you out of my hair, then fine.
Playing to the persuasion perk chat gets you out of so much like time wasting. An ear grub. All right, there's the maps. Like a literal, like old-fashioned map. It's not like a digi map. Kind of boring to get through with a game like that, though. I gotta be honest, like, yeah, well, you talked me out of it. Here you go. Went to all that trouble for nothing.
All right, let's see if we can find the empty nest. All right, let me think. The way I heard it, the readings he was getting were normal at first, then they bottomed out. And no creature, alien or otherwise, would dare step inside. There. Found it. Oh, boy. That's a problem. We'll be fine. Just gotta take a look at what we're up against. First, it's in the middle of the frontier, which we already expected. No problems there but the usual tussling with alien wildlife. But the empty nest is a cave right in the middle of Shawgang territory. Same outlaws who held up Galbank. Well, just remember, it's about the artifact, not them.
Free air conditioning in Florida was believed to be a swampy hellhole where no one could really live.
Let's get to that cave.
Remember, a few native groups escaped there since they knew Americans would not want to stay. Yeah, it was just a penal colony for the Spanish originally, wasn't it? Like, that gives you an idea of what they were thought. That, yeah, we can just put our criminals here. Same with, like, the British with Australia. Then everyone came up with, you know, the glory of AC was invented, and these places could become, like, vacation spots suddenly. You drop your sex, tunt. Let's give it back to Spain. They would probably take it. You know, Florida's pretty valuable real estate. Like, you just want to, like, give us, like, several hundred billion dollars worth of real estate? Fine, we'll take it, America. Take that off your hands. Uh, know what? You can spawn in behind me as I run over there, right? Mexico can have Texas back too. Okay, hold up. That's where we get most of our oil. You guys are like ready to give away all the things that actually allowed us to become a superpower in the first place. Originally, Britain sent their prisoners to the 13 colony. Well, a lot of them, yes. They did use it a way of, well, I mean, they clearly wanted to colonize it, but, you know. It's a lot easier to convince prisoners to do the, you know, do the hard work of establishing one.
A full body workout here.
So they would like, wouldn't they like send over like a prisoner plus like a prostitute or something? I remember reading something about that. Like, we can send you this new place, you can no longer be in prison, but you have to like marry a prostitute. Could you imagine that deal? It's like, wait a minute, you mean I get to get out of like this horrible British prison and I get to have sex on like a new place where you won't like be able to lock me up again? Sign me the fuck up. And then they get over here and it's like, well, looks like you're living in a mud cabin and like dying of dysentery. You're from Brazil and I hear people comparing to Florida a lot, at least the heat. I take it that Dargan's home is snowy kind of place. No, I'm actually kind of like in a unique location in that it doesn't get too warm or too cold. It's kind of like a very temperate location. Like, we'll have like hot and cold days, like extreme ones every once in a while, but generally it's more livable. Not too bad. Dardasil lying. No, I wish. Get your rock, your foot off my mineral. Imagine being sent to a place with koalas and being told this was your punishment. Then again, the spiders, their count as SCP, so take a good... What's really... Isn't it only like... Like a... I know the funnel web spider looks like a fucking monster bred for war. But isn't... Are there really that many terrible spiders on Australia? I thought it was just that one. But at least that's the one you know you gotta work... That's like the fatal one you don't want to get bit by. I'm from Kenya, yes. How did you guess? Tried to keep that hidden for so long. Be careful about mining. That stuff will fill your inventory up fast. Thought I was from North Korea. My dude, there are no streamers in North Korea.
Yeah, a bit of a hair trigger there.
Hallucinogen? I picked up drugs? Holy shit, this place is great. I just picked up shrooms. Fuck it, let's eat them. Why wait? Let me drink my coffee first. Where's my drugs? Well, I'm not sure where they would actually put them. Maybe it's in resources. Yeah, there we go. Oh, rare organic resources. I can only craft it. I can't get high from it. What a boring use of a drug. You picked up heroin. You can only use it to craft, like, you know, new materials. And I don't recognize the accent if I had to guess. South Illinois. Well, South is definitely involved in my region, but I'm more like... my accent, my accent isn't really matched the location I was born and raised in. So you won't be able to like pick up where I'm from based off that, since I have a unique voice that apparently no one else has. I don't know. But one of my mods here is actually from Chicago. And we sound nothing alike. But no, I usually don't, I don't reveal where I live for like privacy reasons. But I do reveal that it's in like East Coast time, US. And I'm more southern direction. So, but that's a pretty big, broad area. Dart's location is basically country roads. Well, You might as well say you think I live in West Virginia if you're gonna say that. You're kind of a radio announcer type, yeah, I guess so. I mean, I'm not trained to sound that way, I just do. Hazardous weather, sandstorm. Do you remember that meme, Chad? Of course you do. Oh. Kill it. It might be friendly, but it's deadly. Give me its fluids. Redacted city, parts unknown. You're making me sound like The Undertaker. Top guesses, Virginia, Tennessee, or Kentucky. Could be any one of those. Could be none of them. They all fit the bill, though. That type of voice is kind of going away since not that many train in the old fashioned. Like I said, this is not... I'm not... What the fuck? Seeing this shit, Sam? Got giant elk and like mantises, birds moving by. But yeah, my voice is just how I sound. This isn't like a trained like actor voice. Hold up, I'm gonna get these drugs. Don't bother me. What's another creature besides that Australian spider that would make you go keep this shit, this house, I'm out of here upon seeing it? Centipedes. Centipedes are like, nope. Plenty of centipedes out there I don't want to mess with. Look at all that trunk, all that junk in it. Ah, chat. It's sad that none of us will actually ever get to go to another planet. And like see shit like crazy new, you know, animals and stuff. Is it though? I don't know. Would you not like to like, you know, maybe have all a right. Sense of exploration this once? Oh, the Shaw gang, huh? Well, we can just open fire on them from up here. Nice throw, idiot. Get out now. No, no, actually fling him, would you? God damn it, game. He just like barely touches him. Here, maybe if I like... Yeah, throw... Use my Inferno grenades, would you? Yeah, he's throwing... Oh, or, yeah, what the fuck? Seen an isopod before? You mean like the little roly-poly insects? I don't even remember where I got this gun, but it's so like good early game. This freaking sandstorm had to roll in right as we like started our fight, didn't it? This feels like going back.
What'd you shoot?
Oh, they're, I think they're almost dead. Straight. Plus I need to refill my shotgun ammo. Space trucker cargo, damn straight I'm taking that. Ever seen specifically those ones that look infant size that you could cradle? Are those fake? I'm not sure. Death is profitable for a businessman like myself who deals in it. Yeah. Death is an everyday part of my life. What we got inside here? The Bridger. David Copperfield again. Dark can, dark lager. No, I'm good. Tasteless. Be careful about picking too much up, otherwise I will just get overburdened again. I'm good for a little bit. Space trucker, space, god damn it. When you call something space trucker, I automatically kind of want it.
When's Shaw coming back? We need to talk about that bank job. She should have been there.
Boss can't be at every job.
Ooh. Oh, these people still alive when I just had a, like having a casual conversation. We just shut up the place.
Not much of a Shaw gang if Shaw never shows up.
She'll be back soon. You can complain all you want. Her face.
What was that?
There's someone inside this house. Oh, my bad, dude. My bad. Oh, hey, wait. Were you talking to yourself in there? I swear I heard you talking to somebody. I know I heard this person talking to someone in here.
Quite a few smugglers back in the day. They know how to party.
You go on, I just got a gun that sets people on fire. I'm not that scary. Okay, now the game's actually kind of interesting. Turns out you let me just like do horrible things to my fellow men and I'm all of a sudden all smiles, Chad. All smiles. Hmm. Needed sealant. Just found out that Baldur's Gate 3 took 6 years to make while the game took, well, this game took 8, yep. And also, Baldur's Gate 3 had been in, like, early access for most of that time, so they were, you were able to play, like, a good portion of it, which helped them, like, refine it during that time. Actually, Baldur's Gate 3 is one of the best arguments I've ever seen for early access and how it can actually help improve a game, rather than just help fund a game during its early development. For like small developers, it's like some of the best playtesting you can actually get. Alright, looks like that's everything. Let's go down into the cave. And you can't stress it enough, Paul. It's racism, you know. Alright, so I could have done like stealth work and like turned the turrets on them as well as turned the robot against them, but you know what? I'm fine with my choices. It seemed like a proper ambush when the sandstorm picked up. Begin of ambush. Oh, okay, they can do the same to me.
Spoiling up there.
In my defense, I didn't know that was explosive. Sand is cold, so I know it's everywhere, right? I mean, to be honest with you, sand does kind of suck. It does get everywhere. He wasn't wrong about that. It's only good to walk on. Equinox though. It's a better Equinox. Same Equinox. Well, that's, you need an expert to get into that, huh? Sand can also be used to cook. I've seen it used for like, yeah, you can heat the sand up. I've seen it used to make Turkish coffee with, actually. It's like, they'll like, have the sand heated up and they'll put their little bronze pot inside it and move it around. You know, I picked up a lot of weapons. Let me check them out real quick. Hey, that is kind of shit, but we'll sell it and make some money. These aren't that great. What does it mean if it has an exclamation mark by the gun? The Ashed Tamer. It surprised. Thank you. Weirdly enough, I'm just really digging my little, like, pistol that sets people on fire. Can't even hack this stupid thing.
expensive. What we got here? That's where I came in, isn't it? Shit. Yep, that's where I came in.
We do what we must, right?
I've actually had pork and fish cooked in sand. So do they have to wrap it in something first? Increases accuracy range, increases damage done. Okay, you need to like use your stuff. Okay. How's the game? At times it can be enjoyable, but there's plenty of times where it's not. Like right now I'm actually enjoying it. When I'm just like killing people and doing some combat and it's like working. But earlier there's whenever I have to like go somewhere, it's like smile fades because it's just so cumbersome. Or do anything else besides shoot people generally. This or Armored Core 6? I'm not sure. Those are two very different things, you realize. I'm not sure how I'd actually even go about telling you which one is for, but they're like, it's like for two different groups of people. I believe I inhaled some of that gas and have a status effect on me. Yeah, what do I got? I got acute lung damage. Do I have anything that will heal that? It's burns and frostbite. Improves fortitude and pain tolerance. Improves articulation, theoretically making the user more charming. Riz drugs. Fractured skull, sprain, meal pack, ramen. That ain't gonna help me any. Yeah, apparently I just do not have anything to cure like my lungs right now. Drugs can give you fake riz. I mean, there is an element of truth to that. Depends on the drug though, I guess. Let me use those stolen med packs instead of like my fresh ones so I can hurry and get the heal that illegal stuff off me. Oh wait, okay. I didn't use them. Watching Nightmare on Elm Street 4 and got into the scene where he turns into a girl into a bug. I've only ever seen like the weirdest one called Dream Warriors. I've never really watched Freddy Krueger, I guess. It never seemed like it was on TV, like, unlike, say, like, Halloween or, like, Friday the 13th movies were. I never really understood that. It's like, it always seemed like it got snubbed a little bit. That's the third, it's pretty good, but it seemed really weird. And it seemed like it was way less violent and more toned down, since it's about kids using their dream powers, like, stop Freddy Krueger. I'll like that. I need this stuff later, chat. It might be useful. The first one is really dark. Yeah, I know that much. Usually the first any successful horror movie is really dark before it gets goofy. Goofy stuff comes later when they hope they can, like, get more people to watch by toning it down a little bit. Chad, Chad, do any of you have, like, a favorite horror movie? Oh, I think we found the thing we came here for. Like, specifically, like, those older horror movies. For me, it was always, like... For some reason, I really liked Hellraiser. You know, the pinhead guy. I just really liked his look. And he was so supernatural. But when it came to slasher films, he always preferred, like, Halloween. Leprechaun in space. I've never seen the Leprechaun movies, but I kind of always wanted to because I heard they're just like cracked out. That movie Goblin, it's like where the goblin's like, oh my god, they're eating her. For like the corny horror movie. I did when I was a kid. There were some Friday the 13th movies I enjoyed, which I says a lot since you shouldn't be watching those as a kid. Yeah, Troll 2. Shouldn't be watching Friday the 13th movies as a child. But I did. I admit it, I liked some of them. I specifically like the one about the psychic girl who, like, ends up, like, using her psychic powers to fight Jason. Jeepers Creepers. I've actually seen that. I've seen half of it, but it is good. Troll 2, and there's a surprise. It's not a sequel to Troll 1. Yeah, it's like a spiritual sequel. Alright, give me the artifact. Use a weapon to break up the deposit. Sam is talking to me, but he's not here. Friday the 13th, part 7, first time Kane Hodder donned the mask. Yeah, there's been like several Jasons, right? Not really horror, but I remember fearing the soil as a kid. Tremors, yeah, that's a good one. Tremors is like Jaws, only for like worms. There is a horror movie I like, but it's probably super corny. It's about spiders called Arachnophobia. It had like this like Amazonian spider from Brazil, like this mutant Amazonian spider from Brazil hitching a ride to like suburban America and then like mating with a common house spider and producing like super monster spiders or something. It was dumb. Yeah, it's definitely dumb, but you know what? It's still kind of a fun movie to watch. I remember it always being on TV. I think a lot of the movies that actually got on the TV are going to be my favorite horror movies because I actually watched them more than once. You remember Eight-Legged Freaks? I never saw that one. But the title has me interested. Where'd my friend go? He was supposed to be following me down this place and he got stuck somewhere, I think. Can't watch Arachnophobia because you have arachnophobia. Yeah, I think the title of that movie is a fair warning. Did I mine that already? I think I mined that already. Alright. And get some other stuff while we're here. We got room. Just me or a mod that lowers the time to collect minerals would be great. There probably already exists one for that. Wait, oh, what? He's dead? They can die? Wait, but he talked to me a minute ago. I saw his, what the fuck? Yeah, I saw his like text on screen after I picked up the thing. He said, hey, let's get out of here. What do I do now? I thought they couldn't die. You were always immortal when I shot you in the face. Reload? Like, I'm pretty sure, like, they can't die, right? He's just taking a nap. He does have his hand up, you know?
Everything's blurry. Got hit in the head.
Yes. Wake up, Sam.
Got blood in my eyes.
He lives, chat. He's alive. He's paralyzed. I know you're in there, Sam.
Got hit in the head.
God, Bethesda, you've done it again. That is surprisingly shitty fire effects, too, by the way. Holy God. That is lazy as fuck, Luke. Alright, so if we like leave and come back in, will he like... Or maybe he'll spawn in behind me.
Smugglers are about. Might be some goodies around.
Holy fuck! Oh, shit! Put him back! What if I want him dead again? It's even worse now. He's like a fucking zombie. Maybe I did burn out his eyes, mate. Oh, God. Bethesda, how do you do it? Man, I really gotta know what your sauce is. He's running backwards. Hey, can you guys give me some help? My friend is a little busted. Oh no, he is broke. He's speeding up. I want him to be part of this cutscene, as he is. I gotta like move him. He's one of those people who like runs in place, chat, because he doesn't want to like break stride. He never asked for this, I know. Oh god, I'm crying, chat. I got literal tears in the welling up of my eyes. Come on, you can move. I'm just gonna get you over there for this cutscene.
I think that's far enough. Hate to put a hole in the head of Akila's own prodigal son. At least not before we've had a word.
You must
be
he's
fixed.
Fuck. What I am is disappointed. Samco in the flesh, and he's peddling around the frontier with the has-beens of Constellation. Now you got past my crew, who I pay quite handsomely, I might add. Grabbed something from that weird cave.
You do not probably look like a criminal gang leader, lady.
So, I'm down one hideout.
I'm sorry, but I'm not buying
now,
it.
Let's talk about what all that's worth to me. Your lives, your credits. One or the other, really.
You know what? I'm just gonna kill all of you.
Kill them!
What is that thing? Why is that? There's like a monster attacking everyone. I mean, I'll take it. I'll take randomness here. Go on, have your way with them! I'll stay back here and let it just like eat them alive. Where are you going? They might have killed the monster I was attacking them. I think some of that penicillin, though. Actually, maybe they're still fighting it. I think they're on the run. Oh no. I don't think this thing was supposed to appear here. It just kind of like lucked out and we got it. Or maybe it's one of theirs and they just aggroed on them. I'm not sure what happened. I think these might have been theirs and they aggroed on them. Yeah, that was a, like an optional objective to kill those things. Where'd he go? He's gone. This mission broke in every possible way, Chad. Like, every possible way it could break. Like, the animals they brought to sick on us ended up attacking their own people. Like, my partner bugged out. It was that was how a proper Bethesda mission should wrap up. Yeah, there was three of these things, and I guess they killed one of them after an aggroed on them.
Life in all its messy glee splendor.
Alright. I think we've got everything. This is the best game in history? No, it's just another Bethesda game. They all do this. Every Bethesda game is busted as hell and jank and will like break on you in funny ways if you give it an opportunity. Alright, we just gotta get back to the ship now. So does this, on this mission, does this storm happen every time you do it? I kind of feel like that was like always how it happens and wasn't just random.
Also, these weather effects are really terrible. What is the plot of this game? The main plot is still just find alien metal that floats, and that's it. We know nothing about it other than it gives you visions of something, and that's it. Maybe after we deliver this piece, we'll actually, like, get a hint of that, what the plot is gonna be. Kinda spooky out here, ain't it? So my, what is my status? Lungs damage, cellulitis. I got a fever. And poor air quality. This planet, how am I breathing all this in when I got a helmet on, by the way? Oh, fuck. I had to buy some drugs. Character in Skyrim didn't give you the key they were supposed to, so you couldn't get to the most of the DLC. What you have to do then? Start like reinstalling. Okay, I think we're almost back to the ship. Buddy is really skilled for a corpse. He's got a good gun. You like farting or something? What is this? This is helium. Oh, fuck. Can I mine that, though?
Well, whatever you were aiming at is so dead. It's like
that. Rock. Well, I've already got enough lung issues. I shouldn't go breathing that in as well. My lungs, chat. This is a working man's lungs. Into the mines, breathing all that stuff. Good for you. NPC can walk around without a helmet. Well, this planet has breathable atmosphere. I'm just wearing it because it gives me better protection. You'd think it would also give you protection against ailments like that. Also, the jetpack stuff sucks. Let me show you how long it looks. It works for. It's like you need a little, maybe it's just this particular jetpack, but it only gives me like a brief burst and that's it. Black, no, space lung is what they would call it now. Kilo wheat. For mind of a dupe. It's really hard to mess up jetpacks. I'm assuming other jetpacks maybe give you different burst patterns. I don't know. Talk, great Laredo camper. Talk to the girl. What mission did you just give me? Talk to the girl. What girl? I guess it's those two since they're different colored. But I don't really care. Oops, oops, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to throw a grenade in front of you. It's alright, none of you will die. Thought maybe that would like aggro the wall on me.
Shouldn't be a problem. You sure he doesn't have Mr. Wright pays overtime?
Like no one even paid attention. Like, yeah, that happens regularly here. Grenade mistakes. Well, it's to me, my credit, that the key to throw them is right there. Still, yeah, still a cred stick. Police code on you. Throw a grenade in public? Nah. Fine. Alright, we made it home. Now we just gotta go back to the lodge and turn in the metal.
You know, this ship isn't so... See you later.
Hmm? Do you need something?
Yep, it's getting a little crowded, Chad. Now we need to put our resources away because I got too much stuff on me. Though I am gonna run up against the limit of my... I can only hold so much more. They'll start using some of this soon. I think I did that wrong. I fucked that up. I didn't go in. Yeah, I took stuff out of my ship again because it's fucking confusing. God damn it. Of shit though. I need to start making stuff with this. I think you can build a base too, right, in the game, or multiple bases? Maybe I should do that. Alright, that's that. This container. Oh, I can't hold anymore. Shit. Run out of storage space. Need more cargo, chat. Alright, but let's go back and like turn in my mission. Good morning, AI guy. What's up, man? How you doing today? Does your family watch my streams? No. Oh yeah, I should say before I get it, do anything else. No. My mom does not have any interest in video games, and I don't think my little brother watches, even though he does play video games. I don't think he's into watching streaming. You got your day off? I hope you get a few more. You deserve it. I saw on Reddit that there's someone who created an invincible ship in this game that enemies can't shoot down because they figured out ships, enemy ships only shoot toward the center of your ship. So they made what looks like a ship looks like a Lego piece. So there is no technical center, so they can't actually hit it. Temp at work got pissed off at me for getting Friday off. Well, that's stupid. Someone has to get a Friday off. You think your little brother watched one of your sim videos without realizing it's you and thought, why is this asshole disrespecting my hair? It's possible. Maybe. I've never asked him, actually. He knows what I does, though, obviously.
Scan complete. Go ahead and land.
Alright. Lodge, please. Let's hope we get an explanation for what's going on now that we add when we add another piece of this metal together.
Hey, we're back. Newest member of our little family really pulled through for us.
Is anyone hurt? You didn't let Cora handle the artifact, did you? We don't know what effects it might have on someone her age.
Relax, we're fine. Go ahead. Time for that artifact to meet its siblings.
Alright.
Just, what are we building here?
I haven't picked up any kind of frequency or signal coming from it.
That doesn't mean much. This thing could be emitting something we can't even detect. As far as we know, we could be building a gigantic bomb that will blow up as soon as we finish it. Or maybe it's some kind of interstellar children's toy.
Why would either of those things give the discoverer visions and music? It's a message. I'm sure of it.
We just have to hope that finding more of the pieces will give us some clue.
I hear that. Moving forward sometimes means fumbling around in the dark. I think Cora and I can use some downtime, but you let me know if you ever want to team up again. Oh, and since it tends to come up, me and my Rugrat co-pilot work as a team. That's non-negotiable. If I'm coming with, that means Cora's on your ship.
Okay.
Why not? What do you think, Cora?
Jensen's
it's
BA.
Really
He's
nice
in a lot
to have
of games.
More company. New stories, new data.
What? Data? Alright. We're in. Let's see what the galaxy throws at us next.
So nothing, we still need to find more.
Everyone here is recording. Yes, even the kid.
Hey, can you guys give me some stuff for my lungs? They're like, I'm near dead. No?
Remember, you're
representing all of us. Besides Deus Ex, he plays a lot of like side characters usually. Like Deus Ex, only one where he's like the actual main character that I know of. Apparently it's an actual problem for him because his voice, he only has that one type of voice, he can't modulate it much. So it's actually apparently kept him from getting a lot of like other roles.
Ever since I got here,
this is all this is exciting. Cool. Take care of yourself.
These people are family. I hope it feels that way. As much as I love, stay safe, okay?
Alright, so what do we get mission-wise now? For like main missions. Hey, look at that. We've only got like one more main mission to do before something major happens, I guess. Talk to Vladimir. He was in both Splinter Cell. Yeah, he's been in the games for a while. Technically, he was actually a NPC that you can walk past and hear talking all the way back in the first Deus Ex game. I remember I discovered that when I replayed Deus Ex a few years ago. He's like, I think he's like a homeless guy. And he was in that game. Then he eventually became the main character of like the newer ones. I'm wondering now that, you know, I still wonder if they're doing anything with Deus Ex now that it's under that Embracer group. And I wonder if they'll do anything good with it after that what happened to Saints Row. I'm definitely going to have to build a new ship though. My cargo hold is full up on that thing. I can't hold anymore. So I need to like start using it. New Saints Row sucked hard, yeah, so. I know I'm very concerned with any game that is now owned by Embracer Group. Very concerned indeed.
Oh, my chest is really sore, chat. Did bitch press the other night. Jason Schreier of Bloomberg News reported in November Eidos Montreal was in the very early stage development of a new Deus Ex game. Yeah, that's what I figured. I'm also wondering if, since they're now, if they're going to continue with Jensen's story, now they're under new management, or if they're like, honestly, if I were them, I would like do a graphical like remake of the original Deus Ex. Why not? That'd sell big time. People are liking the collector's edition for Starfield, like the $100 version. Or does it come with something like a helmet? I don't know. The result of my character still like coughing from that shit. I'm assuming eventually those diseases eventually go away, or do I have to use drugs to get rid of them? You really love OG Deus Ex? I do. It's one of my, it's either pretty much my favorite game of all time, depending which day you ask me. Comes with a watch. I like a new Mario game. You're getting one this year. New Mario game with a new Mario voice actor, even. Monday or Thursdays. I'm not sure which day. It just depends on my mood on that day. Comes with a smartwatch and digital code etched into a green credit. Okay, that's actually a pretty decent collector's edition gift, I guess. If it's a decent smartwatch. Do you mean a new 3D Mario game? Well, it is in 3D. It just played on a 2D plane. But Mario Wonder actually looks pretty good. I might end up playing that. What if the new Mario voice actor just sounds stereotypical New Yorker? I was kind of low-key hoping that it was going to be his actor in the movie. But no, they tried to, like, the new actor, whoever it is, I don't think they revealed it yet, is just trying to sound like the original Mario voice actor. Not too different, so it's basically the same. But slightly noticeable that it's not the same guy.
Chris Pratt, yeah.
You know, Chris Pratt really made that movie what it was. I still wish his eyes would have remained broken. That was a good laugh we had tonight. Several good laughs, I feel. This game just keeps getting better the more it gets broken. I just want it to break even worse every time I play it. That's all I ask. That will keep me entertained. So, Starfield, if you can continue breaking in amusing ways, you might end up being my game of the year. Just for sheer, hilarity of it. Am I going to bed? I'm definitely done playing the game tonight. I've only got like a few minutes left before midnight. I was just like winding down. You gotta be careful with the cred stick thing though. The game code itself is on it. Showing it on a stream can be a bad idea. Considering they sent the SWAT team after me for stealing one in, the bank. They sent them past the bank robbers to come to me for stealing a single cred chip. You're not too far off. Holly, you have a good night, man. That goes to all of you, actually. You've all been wonderful tonight. Thank you for joining me. Hopefully you enjoyed the stream as much as I did. That was some good shit. I literally had tears coming out of my eyes at moments. I like it when Bethesda games break, chat. It's the best moments. Truly. But the game, honestly, I do have to be honest, the game did get a little bit better tonight. Once I was actually doing, like, that mission, that was pretty decent. I got no real complaints with actually how it was designed. So hopefully it keeps that up. We'll see. I love when you cry. It's kind of weird, but alright, I'll take it. Because Bethesda games aren't fun, they're funny. They can be. They definitely can be. But chat, that's gonna be it for tonight. Tomorrow though, I'm playing Baldur's Gate, as long as like my two partners are available to play with me. If not, we'll play more Starfield. Speaking of, like, my character is dying. But that's it for tonight. If you're new here, hit the follow button. Wait, I did not do that. If you stand still long enough, the game does this. Spooter narration, exactly. So yeah, look forward to Baldur's Gate 3 tomorrow, because I am. But that's it for me. I wish you all a great night. You can follow me if you want, join the Discord if you want. Thank you for any bit subs or gift subs, and thank you the mods. Thank you for your time as well. I will see you all tomorrow. Good night, chat.